The dark shorts and the yellow socks. Here we go then. The Lionesses have been here before as England get us underway. They have reached the semi-finals of the last three major tournaments running, and they have fallen at this hurdle in every single one. It's tonight the night that record is changed. It's tonight the night that they reach the third major tournament final in their history. As Sweden come forward into the penalty area, brilliant save by Mary Earps from Jakobsen inside the opening 25 seconds. What a start that almost was for Sweden. Out for a Sweden throw out on this left-hand side. And there is the danger that the Olympic silver medalists will pose as they come forward once again. Sweden win another throw. Mead with the challenge.
Yep, transitional moments. Sweden will be hungry for those in this game. Jakobsen coming in, making that run from the right all the way across. Shot on target, good save by Mary Earps.
Should be 1-0. It really should be 1-0 to Sweden. England are very fortunate there. Great save from Mary Earps with a left boot, sticks out a leg to make sure that it doesn't go in the far right-hand corner, but Sweden should be 1-0 ahead.
So breathe, Lionesses fans, breathe. 0-0, 1 minute gone here at Bramall Lane in Sheffield as we welcome listeners to the BBC's World Service for this Women's Euro semi-final between England, looking to reach their first major tournament final since 2009, and Sweden, the Olympic silver medalists at Tokyo last year. As Beth Mead swings the ball into the penalty area, cleared away by Eriksson. Georgia Stanway picks it up, 25 yards out, Östersjön plays it to the right-hand side, and Mead, edge of the penalty area, pulls it back, it's behind Kirby, it's poor, and will be cleared away by Sweden. Well read by Millie Bright, ahead of Arsenal's Stina Blackstenius, but it's a poor ball forward from the Chelsea centre-half, and it's played over the top once more, and here goes Blackstenius, the Sweden number 11, down the left-hand side. Lucy Bronze in attendance. Blackstenius, left-hand side of the penalty area, now 25 yards out, central position. Tried to pull it back to Angledal of Manchester City, but her shot is blocked, and the ball is over the top for Ellen White, almost in behind, but it just spins away from her towards Magdalena Eriksson, and Sweden in possession with Natalie Björn.
Yep, Peter Gerhardsen, the Sweden coach, will be delighted with the opening few minutes, with the way the game's gone. Transitional, he'll back his team all day in those moments with the likes of Blackstenius and Rolfo, especially up front for Sweden.
Long ball over the top, no problems for Mary Earps gathering that, and we can take you through the lineups. 0-0, 2.5 minutes played. Mary Earps, Manchester United number one, who's already made a very good save from Jakobsen in the opening minute. She's in goal for England. The back four, Lucy Bronze, Millie Bright, Leah Williamson, the captain, and Rachel Daly. Ahead of them, it's Georgia Stanway, who scored that extra time stunner against Spain that brings England to the last four once again. Kira Walsh alongside her, and then Beth Mead, Fran Kirby, and Lauren Hemp supporting Ellen White, the Lionesses' record goal scorer, just one goal behind Wayne Rooney in the bid to become England's outright scorer in the men's and the women's game. Up front, as England play the ball up to the edge of the centre circle, and here is Fran Kirby turning away from Bjorn and out to the left-hand side. Here goes Rachel Daly, the green boots accelerating down the left. Lays it off to Lauren Hemp, who is taking on Ilicet. Ball into the penalty area is blocked, and it will go out. England are claiming the corner. Our referee, Esther Salveling of Switzerland, says throw. Throw to England deep in Sweden territory, and Sweden have Lindahl in goal, her 189th cap. Former Chelsea goalkeeper, so experienced for Sweden. The back four of Ilicet, Sam Brent, Eriksson of Chelsea, and Glass. Ahead of them, Angledal of Manchester City, Aslani and Bjorn, with Rolfa, Jakobsen, and Blackstenius, the Arsenal forward up front. As England have possession out on the left-hand side, here is Kirby. Pulls it all the way back to Leah Williamson, midway through the Sweden half, ball into the area, looking for Beth Mead. Mead almost managed to direct that header on target, but it's glanced just wide of the far post.
Well, so much has been talked about this, the press from Sweden down the left-hand side. And it's Leah Williamson who gets it out of her feet and then can hit that big, long diagonal ball. I think Beth Mead should score. I think she should throw a head at it. I think she should be more committed to it. I think she just doesn't quite see the flight of the ball, but that is a huge opportunity.
Big chance for England through Beth Mead. Sweden have had their big chance already through Jakobsen, and we are still goalless. 4.5 minutes played. A reminder, in the UK you can watch this match on BBC One, and if you do that via the iPlayer or the red button or the BBC website, if you like, you can choose the option with our commentary as well, or join Robin Cowan and Rachel Brown-Finnis over on the television. As England win a free kick, on the halfway line, and Millie Bright will knock it to Leah Williamson.
Yeah, Stephen was just saying about the Swedish press. We spoke a lot about it, and Aslani already, I'm watching her. She's the one that triggers that press normally, but she's a little bit reserved. She's more worried about Kira Walsh popping into those gaps in the six, getting on a half turn and playing forwards.
Throw to England, Lucy Bronze has it midway through the Sweden half. Goalless here on five line. Here is Stanway, lays it back to Williamson, the captain, out to the left-hand side now. Here goes Lauren Hemp running at Illestead once more. They're doubling up on her. Hemp went down right on the edge of the penalty area. Nothing given by Esther Staveley. Lovely turn by Rachel Daly, but it just dragged the ball a little bit away from her into Jakobsen. One back by Hemp. Lots of turnovers of possession. And Sweden it is who come away with it. It's just played over the halfway line and almost latched onto outside the penalty area. But Fridolina Rulfer and Blackstenius between them can't get a foot on the ball. And England have it with Daly over the halfway line. Frenetic pace in the opening 6 minutes. Here is Kirby down the left-hand side approaching the penalty area. Kirby checked well by Sembrant, who steps up. Hemp's ball into the box. It's claimed by Lindahl at the second attempt. Ellen White was right there putting her under pressure. It's a mile a minute as Lindahl launches the ball over the halfway line. Headed away by Millie Bright. Brought down very well by Aslani, one of Sweden's real star players, but she's challenged by Georgia Stanway. Esther Staveley says that is a foul by Georgia Stanway, and you can hear what Bramall Lane thinks of that.
It was a foul. Georgia Stanway's come from behind to nick the ball off Aslani, but she took her ankles. But yeah, again, that matchup between Aslani and Kira Walsh, both in an excellent position to receive the second ball as Millie Bright knocked it down into that space. And it was an absolute tussle, and Aslani came out on top. Sweden now with the free kick.
0-0. 7 minutes played on Five Live in the World Service. Frenetic start to this match as Aslani chips the ball in to the penalty area, and it bounces all the way through to Mary Earp. Stephen Warnock, we know how dangerous Sweden are at set pieces. They've scored more goals from set piece situations than any other side in these Euros. That is an area in which England have to stay switched on.
Yeah, concentration's everything. I think you listened to Lucy Bronze in the interview before the game, and she said, okay, that might be their strength, but we're very strong at set pieces ourselves, so that confidence to be able to deal with them is huge as well.
Lovely drag back by Rachel Daly. Down the left-hand side she goes for England. Forward to Lauren Hemp, and now back to Daly once more. Daly back to Williamson. Does Rachel Daly have a point to prove this evening?
I think to perhaps everybody outside the Lioness camp, possibly, but inside the camp, absolutely not. And she's just had a fantastic start to the game.
Here comes Sweden. Blackstenius in behind. Bronze trying to get back. Good save by Earps. I think Blackstenius might just have dragged it wide, but Earps made the save. Won't be kept in by Williamson. It is out for a Sweden corner. Goodness me, that was a nervy moment for England once more.
Yeah, it's such a dangerous game what England are trying to do. They've got Frank Kirby and Georgia Stanway trying to play in behind the midfield four of Sweden. So whenever there's a turnover of ball, you've got Kira Walsh isolated against two players. You've got Lucy Bronze trying to go forward, and Blackstenius is so clever. She's just picking the little gaps up in between fullback and centre-half. That is a danger for England tonight.
So corner to Sweden, right-hand side. Aslani is over it. They've got the height forward, Sweden. There's so many tall blonde heads in there. As Aslani swings it in, Earps punches, miscue off the bar. Hacked away to safety by England. We'll come back out to Aslani, who miscontrols over on the right-hand side, but will keep the ball in. Aslani, White is there. White goes diving in. Does enough to block the ball by that far corner flag. Aslani still has it, trying to trick away past Ellen White. That's brilliant defending by England's number nine. But Sweden hit the woodwork and once again come so close.
Actually, no, it comes off Blackstenius. She's just in front of Mary Earps, who's put her arm out to punch it, and Blackstenius has beaten her to the ball and she's headed it off the bar.
Sweden rattle the woodwork. Sweden starting this match strongly. The Olympic silver medalists, but England have won it back in their own left-back position. And now here goes Lauren Hemp. Brilliant skill. Oh, she was clearly dragged back there. Now inside the opening 10 minutes, will this be a yellow card from referee Esther Staveley? If it's later in the game, you would think it might be. Hemp was still inside her own half, but that was a great position for England racing down the left.
How's that not yellow? I just don't understand that. It's blatant. It's so obvious what you're trying to do to stop that counter-attack. It doesn't matter at what stage of the game that is a yellow card.
Yeah, and that set the tempo now for the game from the referee. I was intrigued to see if she was going to do it. She didn't, but that set the pace now.
Let off for Bjorn and Sweden, but England have had a couple of let-offs in front of goal as Rolfa picks it up 25 yards out. Here comes Blackstenius once more. Bronze is with her. Into the penalty area goes Blackstenius, edge of the six-yard box, cleared away by England, but they're hanging on a bit at the moment here as the ball is played forward by Hannah Glass, headed away by England. Kirby goes down under the challenge of Bjorn. Esther Stavely is happy. England managed to win it inside their own penalty area, but they're playing on the counter at the moment, the Lionesses, as Georgia Stanway comes forward down the right-hand side. Here is Beth Mead. Sweden getting the yellow shirts back, 0-0. 10.5 minutes played here at Bramall Lane in Sheffield. Kira Walsh and Lucy Bronze between them. Just slow the play down. Out to the right-hand side now, and Beth Meads. Now Georgia Stanway lays it back to Kira Walsh. Now the England captain, Leah Williamson. England who are on their longest winning run in history. 10 wins in a row. Longest unbeaten run as well. Haven't lost in 18 games, although Sweden hasn't lost in their last 16 since winning that silver medal in Japan last summer. But Stanway drives from the edge of the area. Tight angle, hit it on the volley. Difficult chance. Always spinning wide, is it, Christensen?
Yeah, England seem very happy not to punish Sweden on the transitions unless it's 100% on to counter-attack them. They've come back, kind of, you know, recycled the attack. The ball's ended up with Leah Williamson, who switched the play, pinpoint pass onto Beth Mead's right foot. It was actually Hannah Glass, the Swedish left-back, who fouled Beth Mead, but her touch went into the path of Georgia Stanway, and obviously the whole crowd, as soon as the ball goes near Georgia Stanway, they're shouting, shoot. But yeah, she's miscued it, and not by her standards.
Why not? After scoring such a stunning goal in extra time against Spain, and she scored them throughout her career, Georgia Stanway, as she's deemed to have committed a little niggly foul on Aslani. Ball was definitely moving as Aslani, Sweden captain on the night, took the free kick, and it will be called back for the set piece on the halfway line for Sweden, 0-0.
I know Jonas Eidevold before the game said this will be one on the flanks. I think this will be one in the middle of the park. I think the transitions between the two sets of midfielders is the key in this game.
Magdalena Eriksson, the Chelsea captain, spreads the ball out to the right-hand side for Sweden. Great delivery as well. Rachel Daly back there defending. Dangerous ball in. Lucy Bronze heads away inside the six-yard box. Helped on by England out of the penalty area. Mead will beat Glass to the ball as it spins away. And that's a brilliant ball for Fran Kirby over the halfway line. Ellen Wright is racing through the middle. Kirby stops and checks and pulls the ball back to Lauren Hemp and all the way back to Kira Walsh. All the way back now to Leah Williamson and Izzy Christensen is not happy alongside me.
Well, I just made the point about England getting the moments to attack on the transition, but coming back on themselves and recycling the attack. They seem to be content with dropping Sweden back off into their defensive shape of what looks like 4-4-2 at the moment.
Lucy Bronze intercepted by Fridolina Rolfa, and Sweden are looking so dangerous coming forward. Rolfa into the penalty area, shot on the angle, side netting. Got a little shove in the back there as well, Rolfa, but Blackstenius through the centre, Stephen. It's just looking so dangerous, and England aren't dealing with that threat through the middle.
No, they're not at all. This time it was a mistake from Lucy Bronze. I've got to say, I think Millie Bright has to miss her out there. I think you've just got to look a little bit further forward, a little bit more direct. We know the press of Sweden. We know how good they are. They set traps. They make it difficult. Lucy Bronze trying to take a player on in the wrong position. If you do get caught out, that's what you're going to expect against the top team.
England in possession midway through their own half. 0-0 in this Women's European Championship semi-final. England looking to reach their first major tournament final in the women's game since 2009. It would only be their third major final in their history. One step from Wembley, but so far it's Sweden, ranked second in the world, who are having the better of this match. They've hit the crossbar through Blackstenius. England play the ball through the centre now, trying to undo them. Here is Ellen White, lays it off to the left-hand side, and Lauren Hemp back all the way to Kira Walsh, who goes back to Williamson on halfway.
I don't know how you guys feel, but I feel a little bit more uncomfortable against Sweden than I did against Spain, where, okay, Spain had all the possession, but they never really hurt England. I feel like Sweden are hurting England every time.
Here comes Stanway, great ball, space for Bronze, right-hand side, White's in the centre, Bronze pulls it back, Mead's delivery in, headed away by Eriksson before Lindahl can reach it. That was nervy from the Sweden defence, and it results in an England corner.
Yeah, excellent through ball into Lucy Bronze, overlapping fullback, fakes just cross, cuts back. Beth Mead, excellent delivery into the box. And you know what? I'm going to say it, Lindahl, in goal for Sweden, has not looked confident for me all tournament. She came out for that cross then, and luckily Eriksson headed it away for the corner, but I don't think she was going to get near it. She'd left a goal, leaving it completely wide open. Yeah, she's not looked confident. I'd say get crosses into the box onto her.
So, discussion going on down by the corner flag for England. Can they test Hedvig Lindahl, the very experienced Sweden goalkeeper, once again? Ball swung into the edge of the six-yard box. It's not very well dealt with in the end. It is an England touch that takes it behind. But again, Sweden, for a side that are so tall and are so good attacking-wise set pieces and generally are very good defending set pieces, wasn't the most convincing defending there.
Well, it was Rolfo, the attacker for Sweden, marking Ellen White. I don't think there's anything wrong with that, to be honest with you. Just not a natural defender. But yeah, the ball could have gone anywhere then.
So goal kick to Sweden. 16 minutes played on 5 Live in the World Service. 0-0. As Georgia Samway wins the ball, but only plays it straight to the Arsenal striker, Blackstenius, for Sweden. Jakobsson's through the centre. Aslani advancing now as well. Angeldal plays it forward to Blackstenius. Right-hand side up against Lauren Hemp. He's back there defending. Dives in, doesn't get the ball. Bjorn's delivery in is blocked well by Georgia Samway. Spins away to Sembrant, just inside her own half for Sweden. But England only have Ellen White up there on the halfway line. She's already putting in a shift, Ellen White. England's record goal scorer, but Sweden just play around England now. Aslani threading the ball through the line, straight then to Rachel Daly. Williamson takes the touch inside her own penalty area and will clear, only to Natalie Bjorn. Sweden are having the better of this at the moment, but it's still goalless as they take it down by the right-hand corner flag. Kira Walsh gets a foot in, gets the touch as well of Kosovare. Aslani throw to England, deep in England territory.
Yeah, England need to take the sting out of Aslani's play already. She's already starting Aslani to dictate. She just put a foot on the ball there and turned and took through, broke the midfield line with one touch just then. And that's just a sign for me that Aslani's starting to turn it on a little bit.
England give possession away from the throw, deep inside their own territory. Aslani plays the ball in off Rachel Daly. Corner, and is he right, Stephen? Aslani is dictating things for Sweden.
Yeah, here at Blackstenius, so clever. And I mean, the runs of Blackstenius. I was just thinking then when she came to Arsenal and you had obviously Vivian Miedemar as well, and you're thinking, how do they play together? Their absolute football intelligence, the brains that both of them have got, it was always going to work, and you can see why that did work. She's so clever.
Full credit to Jonas for getting them going together.
Yeah, absolutely. As Esther Stavely, the referee, just having a word with Sina Blackstenius, who's laughing at whatever Stavely said to her. I'm not sure it's always wise to laugh at a referee, but there we go. Corner for Sweden to be taken from the right-hand side. Swung into the packed six-yard box. Once again, Eriksson was in there, tried to chest it towards goal. Hacked away by England. Jakobsson will send it back in. Lucy Bronze wins the header out of the penalty area. Beth Mead then tumbles on the edge of the box, and Esther Stavely will call it back, and it will be a free kick to England just outside their own penalty area. Mead crouches down. Just on Blackstenius there, that's something that Jonas Eidevall pulled out when he signed her for Arsenal. He said that that is one of her big strength. She's so good at getting in behind the defence, and particularly a defence that plays a high line. Running in behind, she's so dangerous, and we're seeing that already, aren't we?
It's okay to say running behind. You've got to know where to run and when to run and make sure that it's timed properly. Her timing is so good. It's so clever. And the midfielders know as soon as they pick the heads up, she'll be where they want her. She'll be where they want her to be.
Stanway loses the ball in the centre circle there. She says she was tripped. Fortunately for England, referee Esther Stavely agrees. And England have a free kick. 19 minutes gone on 5 Live in the World Service. England 0, Sweden 0 in this Women's Euro semi-final.
Yeah, it's smart from England. Kira Walsh being marked out of the game so far by Aslani. So Georgia Stanway drops a little bit deeper. Georgia Stanway is very good at carrying the ball on the move because she's a strong runner. And I think that's really working for them. Stanway dropping in and starting off attacks alongside Kira Walsh.
Sweden win possession, then lose possession midway through their own half. Here is Stanway. England coming forward with pace. Hemp, edge of the box, there's to shoot. Still going, Lauren Hemp. Lays it off to Beth Mead inside the penalty area. Curls the shot in, chested away, and Sweden will clear it away on the edge of their own penalty area. Leah Williamson will come across to stop the counter, and it's still goalless.
Good play from England. Beth Mead, Lauren Hemp driving inside. combining. Lauren Hemp getting not favoured to take the shot on her right foot as she's cut inside. Crowd are again urging her to shoot. They just want to see an England attempt, you know, to keep them going. But yeah, good sign for England, but need a little bit more quality so far in the final third.
They've been spoiled by Stanway from range. England's in possession. Here is Millie Bright midway through the England half. 0-0. Beth Mead will chase this. Hannah Glass intercepts. Georgia Stanway chests it down midway through the Sweden half. Central position. She's challenged. They know about the danger, Sweden. Stanway picks up the ricochet out to the left, and Lauren Hemp into the penalty area. Pulls it across. White first time. Bobbles into the arms of Linda.
Yeah, it's a good bit of defending by Magdalena Eriksson, the left-sided centre-back for Sweden, just to stop Ellen White getting a free shot at goal. She's done enough to put her off. That whole centre-half trick to lean into the player. She ends up getting the deflection, and Lindahl comes and collects it easily.
I think one of the things that we saw against Spain, when England were at the best, they missed the press out. We just saw it there from Millie Bright. Forward ball goes up to the front, then you pick the seconds up, and then you can really attack the back line of Sweden.
Going back to that Stanway point, dropping in deep alongside Kira Walsh, it's isolating Natalie Bjorn. I'm just watching her now. She doesn't know whether to go with Stanway and leave that number 10 area vacant for Frank Kirby or not. And it's causing Sweden all sorts of problems in that midfield.
Sweden causing England problems down the left, though. Intercepted by Williamson before Aslani can latch onto it. But Sweden take the throw so quickly. Nice one, too. Rolfa's ball into the area just ahead of Blackstenius. An excellent interception by Rachel Daly before Jakobsen could latch onto it on the right-hand side of the penalty area. 0-0, midway point in the first half as Jakobsen's ball across, just about away by Leah Williamson inside her own six-yard box. But again, Sweden so dangerous in those areas. Earps wasn't sure, didn't know whether to come or stay. It's only just over the blonde head of Blackstenius as Ellen White goes down. Free kick to England just inside their own half. Stephen Warnock, again, they've got to sort it out, England. Blackstenius, just every time she's in that penalty area, you think, oh, goodness me.
Yeah, but when you're in a wide area and you know you've got a quality striker like her, feed the ball in early. The quality of the crosses coming in from either side is, it's one touch, it's feed it in there. It's not looking to hit her head, it's just looking to hit an area difficult to defend.
Here goes Rachel Daly down the left-hand side for England, and now Hemp. Approaching the penalty area, lays it off to Stanway, checks, will now shoot again. It's tame, just didn't catch it cleanly, and Lindahl will gather.
Yeah, Stanway in that all familiar area on the edge of the D, the Swedish 18-yard box, and Natalie Bjorn, she goes to press Georgia Stanway, knowing full well of her capabilities from the edge of the box. Georgia Stanway fakes the shoot, cuts inside, and ends up being a bit more of a tamer left foot shot into the hands of Lindahl.
Sweden in possession with Hannah Glass. Natalie Bjorn, a player that you know very well, is he? Club teammates at Everton. As Sweden go over the top again. Cleared away by Lucy Bronze. Low clearance intercepted by Beth Mead. Sweden will win it back though with Everton's Bjorn. And now Aslani out to the left-hand side. So many yellow shirts there. Jakobsen pulls it back. Sliding challenge cleared away. What a tackle by Frank Kirby. Because Angeldahl had ghosted into the penalty area. Kirby tracked her all the way. She gets it wrong. It's a penalty or a goal. She gets it right, and England clear, and it's still 0-0.
Yeah, so often we see Frank Kirby on the receiving ends of challenges like that, but that is unbelievable for her team because that is a certain goal. Philippa Angeldahl in that area for cutbacks. I'd back it all day to hit the net. Frank Kirby, I'll super from her.
Here she is on the ball, Frank Kirby, midway through the England half. England's second best at the moment against the side, ranked second in the world. But it's goalless. Here is Lucy Bronze. White went and checked, then went again, and Bronze, not sure whether she was onside or not, finds Kirby instead. Now Rachel Daly picks it up for England, and now Hemp, left-hand side, cuts in field, trying to slide it through to Kirby. It's well intercepted by Illestet. Angeldahl, under pressure, will try and turn away from her Manchester City teammate, plays it back to Sembrant, who lifts it forward to Aslani. Interception well made by Frank Kirby, out for a Sweden throw midway through their own half.
Just get to that point where you're like, and breathe. I mean, the players, the effort, the way that they're closing each other down, this has been breathtaking. What a start to a semi-final. I say a start, I mean, what are we, 25 minutes in nearly? Quite
flown
brilliant.
Flown by. Sweden win a throw just inside the England half. And this is the thing, I think you're seeing two sides that know they have to go 100% from the first whistle, because if they let off,
if they drop 5% below their level, it's enough to lose because they are so finely matched. As England, very well through Daly, win the ball deep by their own corner flag, left-hand side. She does very well there, Daly, as well, to prevent the corner.
Very good from Rachel Daly. Sweden have tried on the last couple of occasions to just go in behind England's defence on that left-hand side, in behind Williamson and Daly. Jakobsen is a player who is very quick and very aggressive. Rachel Daly does a really good job at just shielding the ball out for a goal kick and taking a little bit of pressure off her team.
Izzy, what's your view on Leah playing on the left of the two? Because so often we see her at club level playing on that right and she drives out and starts attacks.
Yep.
Don't see much of it this tournament, have we?
No, and I think playing her on that side, you take away, you know, a bit of a game in terms of distribution. I really do think that naturally she's right-footed. I mean, she's gifted on her left. She's a right-footed centre-half, and her playing out from the back is what's got her to where she is in her career. And I just think you're taking a little bit of that away from her by playing her on that left.
Izzy Christiansen and Stephen Warnock with us here on 5 Live. 0-0 in this Women's European Championship semi-final. Lead away by Hedvig Lindahl, who is in the bright orange, think Netherlands-style kit for Sweden. In goalkeeper for them, that number one spot since 2005. This is her 15th major tournament with Sweden. That includes the Olympic Games as well. Of course, England don't compete in those. They've had two goes at it as Team GB, as Sweden win the free kick just inside their own half, or as part of Team GB, I should say. Sweden, Olympic silver medalists, only on penalties as well against Canada last summer. Play the ball into the penalty area, cleared away by the head of Williamson, and out for a Sweden throw midway through the England half, goalless.
Sweden are very equipped for the second ball game as well. All over the park, they've got players who can read where the ball's going to land, and that's why they're so good on transitions, because they anticipate where the ball is and then they make it into an attack.
Busy night for Lucy Bronze as Rolfe plays the ball past her. Bjorn into the penalty area, still going, pulls the ball across. She's been penalised for the foul there, the Everton midfielder. Millie Bright had made the block anyway. Nervy moments again for England.
Not so sure it's a foul. I think she just loses her footing. Yep. And it is very, very fortunate that the referee blows the whistle and Georgia Stanway gets away with one.
Tell you what, it's fortunate as well that it wasn't a goal, because if VAR look at that, I think it stands. But obviously, because the referees decided to give the free kick, you stop. But Sweden was still in a good position, even though Bright had made the block. Right, it is in possession in the penalty area for England. Goalless here on 5 Live in the World Service. A reminder, you can watch on BBC One. If you do that via the iPlayer or the red button or the BBC Sport website, you can choose the option with our commentary if you wish. And remember, all the reaction to this match on the Daily Euros podcast. Download that from BBC Sound tomorrow morning as England spread it out to the left-hand side. And Lauren Hemp taking on Illestet. Hemp still going. Illestet gets a foot in. But that is a battle where Lauren Hemp is coming off better against Illestet in that 1v1.
Yeah, I'd back Lauren Hemp all day up against Illestet. To be honest with you, looking at the defending of Illestet there, we're breaking it down. She's gone in on Lauren Hemp inside the 18-yard box in a very risky situation. With the left leg, she should have gone on her right leg, because on her left leg, she was off balance. And I just think if you're off balance as a defender with Lauren Hemp running at you, you've got trouble ahead.
So corner to England, 0-0, 28 and a half minutes played here at Bramall Lane. England players running from the penalty spot. The corner is swung. Lucy Bronze wins the header. And it's wide and it's behind for a Sweden goal kick.
Lovely quality again. You talk about how good you are at defending set pieces, or what your strengths are. You're only as good attacking the ball as the quality is coming in, and it's also the opposite for the defensive team. When the quality comes in of that sort of precision, it is very, very difficult for defenders to defend against.
So goal kick to Sweden, approaching half an hour gone, 0-0 at Bramall Lane. Mentioned Viviana Miedemar a few minutes ago, Stephen. She's here tonight in the stands wearing an England shirt. That's nice of her. Netherlands are out, of course, so she can turn her attention to supporting her club teammates. Although, of course, Stinius plays for Arsenal as well. But Beth Mead, Leah Williamson, she's behind them this evening and behind the country in which she plays her club football. Lucy Bronze wins the throw for England, just level with England's penalty area on the right-hand side. And local lads, Harry Maguire here as well, of course, now of England and Manchester United. As the ball goes out of play, England can see possession straight from that throw, and Sweden with a throw on the halfway line.
There's some afters going on between Magdalene Eriksson and Ellen White on that left-hand side off the ball. They were holding each other. I'm not quite sure which way it was. I imagine Eriksson was holding Ellen White back from the spinning behind. Ellen White is so smart. Look, they're going at it again. Look, I can just see them. Look, Ellen White wants the ball. She's screaming for the ball. She's got Magdalene Eriksson on a string.
Kirby dispossessed, wins it back, dispossessed again, wins it back. Great play by Fran Kirby, appreciated by the fans here in Sheffield. And now Beth Mead has the ball on the right-hand side. Now in field to Leah Williamson, out to the left and Rachel Daly. 0-0 on 5 live in the World Service. Lauren Hemp forced back to Rachel Daly once more. Plays the ball towards the edge of the penalty area. White is up there. Eriksson wins that battle on the ball this time. But it spins out. Space for Mead on this right-hand side for England. Glass comes over to cover. Mead's ball in his paw. Rolfa is challenged by Mead. He's trying to win the ball back. Prevent the goal kick. Doesn't do so. Goal kick Sweden.
Yeah, not up to Beth Mead's normal standards in that area on that right-hand side. She's been a little bit slow to get in the game, but said that player's of her ability, she'll just bring it to life soon, I'm sure.
Here is Kosovare Zani for Sweden, wins it on the right-hand side. As Sweden now bursts down the right with Jakobsen, plays the ball in, looking for Blackstenius. Vital interception on the corner of the six-yard box by Leah Williamson, and White will pick it up on the halfway line. It's done brilliantly there, White, until she plays the ball, looking for Hemp, and it's poor. And Sweden are off down the right-hand side again. White goes lunging in. Ooh. It's given as a free kick to Sweden. Good position this, right-hand side, midway through the England half, perhaps just a little further forward, nearer to the penalty area, but White back there, initially tussling with Sembrant and then diving in on Angledal, trying to make the block.
Yeah, that's a foul. Ellen White just loses possession. It's 50-50 on the first challenge, but the second challenge, she's been a bit too erratic, conceding a free kick and one of the best deliverers of the ball from wide area, Saslani over it.
Danger here for England. Sweden, who have scored more set-piece goals than any other side in this tournament, looking for the breakthrough 13 minutes before half-time. Aslani stands over it, swung to the edge of the six-yard box, headed away by England, picked up by Angledal, just overruns it. Hemp, her City teammate, is there. Angledal makes the challenge behind for an England goal kick.
Yeah, so often we see Sweden not just win the first contact in the box, but I said they're so good at anticipating the second ball, and Angledal's scored already this tournament from just anticipating the ball dropping inside the 18-yard box and banging it home. She was close to pulling the trigger then. England defended it really well.
Yep, got a couple of goals against Portugal in the group stage. Philippa Angledal, Sweden qualifying top of their group as England did. England doing it with a game to spare, but Sweden always in a tough fight for the top two in their group with the Netherlands, the defending European champions, who were knocked out at the quarterfinal stage by Frances Merriot. Very, very calmly squares that to Millie Bright inside her own penalty area. I'll tell you what, Stephen, you've got to have some composure there when you've got Blackstenius just a foot away from you just to play it out like that.
Yeah, you've got to have confidence. You've got to have the confidence to know what you're looking to achieve, and they're trying to beat this press, and it's led to a great attack.
Here they come, Lauren Hemp into the area. White just can't convert on the edge of the six-yard box. Bronze back in, brought down by Mead, who scores! Beth Mead with the opener for England in the semi-final from one end to the other. And the girl who's chasing the golden boots draws first blood for the Lionesses in the last four. England 1, Sweden 0.
We talked about the press. England beat the press, they work it, they're confident, they get it out to the left-hand side. It's a brilliant ball in from Lauren Hemp into White. She just can't quite get on the end of it, but Lucy Bronze is at the other end, and then she crosses the ball into the box. You've got Beth Mead, takes a touch, spins, left-footed, drills it far left-hand corner, and the goalkeeper has absolutely no chance, and the place, Bramall Lane, has just erupted. Wow.
The best player in the box I have seen all season, controlling the ball, spinning and just banging it across Lindahl across the goalkeeper into the bottom corner. Unbelievable from England.
It's actually come to life.
I did. I called it. Not been great, but tell you what, that's been an impact and a half.
Well, that's it. The overall performance from an individual player matters not a jot if you score a goal as big as that. And what a big goal this is for the Lionesses. Beth Mead, 6 goals for the tournament now. She's too clear of Alex Popp of Germany in the race for the Golden Boot. But individual accolades come second here. It's all about reaching this first final since 2009 for the Lionesses as they clear the ball away inside their own penalty area. Out to the left-hand side it goes for a Sweden throw.
You know where it came from? It came from Rachel Daly. Stephen said they worked the ball, they beat the press. But sometimes the best way to beat the press is just run with the ball. Be stronger, run with it with force. And that's what Rachel Daly did. Slipped in Lauren Hemp. The ball across Ellen White must have been a fingernail away from getting that, breaking that record that you're talking about, Vicky, but instead Beth Mead pops up again.
Yep, just one goal away from equaling Wayne Rooney, Ellen White. Goal in the semi-final, goal in the final? Too soon, too soon. Out to the left-hand side, England have the throw. They lead Sweden by a goal to nil. Rachel Daly takes it, it's over the head of Hemp, it's cleared away by Sweden, and nobody inside the stadium will be writing Sweden off at all. They've been the better side. The ball comes into the penalty area, controlled by the feet of Mary Earps, which just allows her to wait until she's closed down by Blaxenius and then gather inside her own 6-yard box. But England it is who have the breakthrough as Williamson has it outside her own penalty area.
Seeing how Sweden respond now, does anything change from their game plan? Players don't seem to be too concerned. They seem confident that they're going to get back into the game, but I've noticed that every time Sweden have got themselves into a good crossing position, they've only got one player to aim at in the box, and England have got at least 3 defenders in there, and it's going to take one hell of a ball to pick that player out and finish.
Here is Kira Walsh, ball out to the right-hand side. England 1, Sweden 0 on 5 Live and the World Service. Mead digs it forward, looking for bronze, cutting in field, goes down, England play on. Kirby finds Samway, pulls the ball across. Very good interception inside her own 6-yard box, cleared away by Sweden. Stanway's ball back in is gathered by Lindahl. But this is England's best spell of the match.
Yeah, score again while you're on top. Score again while you're on top. Going at halftime 2-0. And the team talk's very different. 2-0 still dangerous, but I'm telling you, England, it's all end now.
Hopefully she bronzes okay. She took a real knock there into a challenge. It was an unorthodox tackle, really, and it looks like she's either got a dead leg or been winded.
So can England keep the ball away from their right back for now? They have it over on the left-hand side. That's what they're doing. Here is Rachel Daly, plays it back to Leah Williamson. England in possession inside their own half. Williamson taking a chance, dispossessed by Aslani. That's a poor decision from Williamson, but it's a poor ball forward from Sweden. And Millie Bright is there to mop up.
Do you know what? She just has to hit a diagonal. Any sense of danger or feeling that someone's close to her, closing her down, just hit the diagonal. It's your safety ball all game.
Here is Beth Mead, England's goal scorer, down the right as they go back to Lucy Bronze. Now Millie Bright once more. England 1, Sweden 0. England, who have only beaten Sweden 3 times in their history. They lost the first European Championship final to them on penalties back in 1984. In their last meeting, they fell in the bronze medal match against Sweden at the World Cup in 2019. But they have the goal advantage here. And as they have it on halfway, play it now over the top, looking for Beth Mead again. Headed away by Glass, brought down by Samway. She will shoot from here and it's over the bar. It's interesting because the support and the noise level inside Bramall Lane has been at a great level. There's almost now this tense excitement that England have scored.
Yeah, it's tense. The fans want another goal and you can hear them every time England get in and around that Swedish 18-yard box or on the attack even. You know, they're right behind them, the screaming, the shouting, they want that second goal cushion. And
can they get it? That's the question for England as Lauren Hemp comes down this left-hand side, won't keep that ball in, and it's out for a throw which in a step will take.
It's almost like they feel, well, Sweden have thrown the best at England and we've took everything that they had, and then we've gone the other end, scored, and now we look more confident. The crowd are starting to believe, and they start to believe that they can win this game.
I was just thinking the exact same, and I'm kind of wondering now, what have you got, Sweden? Because they didn't score while they had that good spell at the start of this first half. not looking around and the players look a little bit flat. And I think Stephen was absolutely bang on with what he said about the game will be won and lost in the midfield, and I'm just seeing it all being all England now in this midfield. Swedish midfield are getting drawn all over the place, gaps are appearing, Frank Kirby's popping in and out of positions, no one knows who to pick her up.
Cleared away by Magdalena Eriksson for Sweden. Down the right-hand side, Jakobsen will chase. Ball all the way back to Mary Earps, who wasn't quite sure what to do there. Player on, shouts the entirety of Bramall Lane, and Millie Bright obliges. Clears it out to the left-hand side. Hemro keep it in, Sweden throw.
Good job she checked her shoulder, Millie Bright. Just got rid of that quickly because she had two Swedish players in Blackstenius and Rolfo pressing her from behind.
England have a player down on the far side. Looks like it might be Kira Walsh, but England are playing on. Lovely layup by Ellen White to Frank Kirby. Here is Mead, space outside the penalty area. White's continue to run. Won't latch onto it in the box. Won't keep it in either, and it's out for a Sweden goal kick.
I was saying, as soon as Frank Kirby picked the ball up, shoot. The goalkeeper was off the line. She was on the edge of the box, and I'm thinking, just hit it. There's a free goal for you there, but perhaps she was just thinking to play the sensible ball, and yeah, probably that's why she plays and I don't, and that's why she's a midfielder.
As she's travelling though, Stephen, Frank Kirby, she's opted to slip Beth Mead in, but that pass needs to be in front of Beth Mead so she doesn't check a run. As soon as she checks a run, the attack's over.
Kira Walsh is up to her feet for England. Sweden coming down the left-hand side. Excellent play by Millie Bright. Plays the ball back into her own penalty area. Lucy Bronze takes a touch, clears only as far as Bjorn of Everton for Sweden. Work it out to the left and Rolfa's crossing. Jakobsen heads it down. Thankfully for England, to the gloves of Mary Earps and not Blackstenius, who was a couple of yards in front of her.
Yeah, it's a warning sign for England just from these wide areas. We're talking about Sweden picking that player out. And on that occasion she did. Rolfa finding her opposite winger in Jakobsen, who's done really well to leap and to glance that header back across goal. But Mary Earps has read it well and come and claimed it. But it's a sign for England to keep their wits about them.
3 minutes plus out of time to play in this first half. England 1, Sweden 0. What a run this is from Lauren Hemp. Drifting into the centre, lays it off to Frank Kirby, who plays it back to Kira Walsh. And Walsh will go all the way back to the captain, Leah Williamson. England enjoying the spell of possession with the goal advantage through Beth Mead. Rachel Daly plays it back to Williamson. Space for Bronze on the right-hand side. Millie Bright instead will go all the way back to Mary Earps. And this is the challenge for Sweden. I mean, England will still come forward. Make no mistake, England will try and get this second goal. But they hammered on the door against Belgium in their quarter-final. And when England do try and sit in, that's a different sort of test for Sweden. How are they going to unlock this England defence?
Well, I think that's what Sweden have struggled with all tournament, Vicky, is intricate passing and finding different ways around teams when they park up. And that's something England can do subtly. It's not England are not a team equipped to park the bus, but they could do just to frustrate Sweden and take the sting out of their play.
Here is Aslani for Sweden. Very good play down the right-hand side. The ball is intercepted, though, by Rachel Daly. Kira Walsh will pick it up. And interesting there, we've seen that a couple of times. Leah Williamson, the left-sided centre-half. When Aslani gets going down the right-hand side, Williamson comes right across. I mean, left-back's another position that she can play as well as central midfield and centre-half, the England captain. But they're making sure that they get the bodies over on Aslani. Yes, it can leave gaps in the centre, but it works on that occasion as the ball is played forward by Stanway. Advantage played as Mead has it. Mead's early ball into the area, four straight into the arms of Lindahl.
Yeah, you can see what Beth Mead was trying to do, which was feed that ball into that corridor in between Lindahl and the centre-backs.
Aslani wants a free kick, not given. Kirby will curl, and Kirby will curl just past the post.
She looked in danger, didn't she, Lindahl? She didn't know where she was in a goal. She just recovered from taking the goal kick quickly. She couldn't quite get her footwork right, and Frank Kirby comes in, tries to open her body up. It was quite wide of the goal, but it's good signs from England, because what they're doing is they're picking them second balls up, and when they are, they're really attacking with intent now.
Frank Kirby is having a stormer.
She is, and she's not being intricate, creative Frank Kirby as much, but she's done a shift for a team backwards defensively, and she's also picked up some very, very intelligent positions in between Natalie Bjorn. She's moving Natalie Bjorn around, a bit like a mannequin. She's saying, right, I'm going to bring you here now, and then I'm going to take you there. Natalie Bjorn doesn't know whether to pick her up. She man marks her, you know, spaces elsewhere. It's so clever. Fran's brilliant at that job.
Millie Bright under pressure from Blackstenius. Back to Werps, who clears up towards halfway into the final minute of normal time at the end of this first half on 5 Live in the World Service. England 1, Sweden 0. Here is Samway, plays it forward to Beth Mead, the goal scorer. Doesn't have options down the right for now, so goes in field to Lucy Bront, who's come central, plays it back to Leah Williamson on the halfway line. Yeah. Forward once more, Lauren Hempty's possessed, we'll try and win it back. Sweden though on the free kick. No, not a free kick, half time, no added time at the end of this half. And it's a half in which England have found the goal advantage. Sweden, the better side on balance, but when you have a quality player like Beth Mead, she can always pop up with a goal, and she's done it again, the player that leads the charts here at the Euros. And what a finish it was, Izzy.
Yeah, it was a finish, you know, really high level finish. Just how she likes it inside the box, on the turn, spinning it. She's so competent on both feet when finishing, you know, just as much power in that shot on her left foot as she can generate on her right. And yeah, just a really good bit of play from England in general. And I think on balance, both teams had their spells in this first half. Obviously Sweden with that very early chance, but yeah, Beth Mead's goal is the difference, and very well deserved.
Huge moment early on in the game, 45 seconds in, Mary Earps makes a huge save that keeps England in the game. And then England, they rode the luck a little bit. They were under a little bit of pressure, but came back into the game. A tactical tweak in midfield, dropping two midfielders in, then overpowered the Swedish midfield. It's been a very impressive performance from England.
Half time at Bramall Lane in Sheffield. England 1, Sweden 0.
Well, what a 45. It flew by. They usually say time flies when you're having fun. I'd probably describe it as a little bit more heart in mouth at times. How would you sum it up, Stephen?
I've enjoyed it. I've really enjoyed it. I've enjoyed watching the tactical tweaks on the pitch. I've enjoyed watching the battles individually all over. I can't believe how quick it did fly, because I looked at the clock and it was suddenly 7 minutes, and I was thinking, wow, that seemed like the quickest 7 minutes I'd seen. Then it got to 25, and then when the whistle went at the end, then I was thinking, like Vicky said, there's a foul. It wasn't, it was half time. That just shows you the quality of the game and how entertaining it's been.
Let's bring in Karen Bardsley once more. How worthy are England of that lead, Karen? Because we alluded to it there. It's a bit of a nervy start, wasn't it? Mary Earps really keeping the Lionesses in that game.
Yeah, I think Steve touched on it a little bit earlier in commentary, but I have to say that save probably has kept England in it. Like, I'm not going to lie. Like, that was such an important moment for England. Being under the, you know, 1-0 down that early in a game could have been potentially disastrous. So it was a great reflex save, you know, a bit of a block, a bit of a spread from Mary Earps, very quick with that left foot. And I was very impressed with that, especially, you know, coming off the back of cooling down off after the warm-up, the anthems and everything, you know, just getting back into the momentum of the game. It's very, very important.
I think one of the things that you, when you look at, if you were to concede a goal after 45 seconds, what that does to a team mentally is huge, because then what it does to the opposition who've scored is mega, because you think, wow, what a start for us. If it happens in the 25th minute, for some reason it feels different. So that save at that point in time was massive.
Despite their lead, I imagine there is a whiteboard in the Lionesses dressing room with Stina Blackstenius' name in bold black underlined. Yes, as the half went on, the Lionesses looked more and more in control and ultimately got their reward with the goal. But she's caused, especially Lucy Bronze down this right-hand side, a lot of problems, hasn't she?
Yeah, you've got to remember she's hit the bar as well. Already, we've just seen it on the replay. Sweden hit the bar, so they've had that early chance in Jakobsen, and then Stenius has hit the bar. So Sweden have been in the game, and yes, exactly that, Emma. There will be her name written, well, I don't know if it'll be written on the whiteboard, but they'll be very, very aware of her threats, and that Sweden can just, they can have a moment and they can just come to life. I was looking down at the bench just before halftime, then the Swedish bench, and I was thinking Hanna Bennison, because the midfield threat that she poses is massive. It's just whether they can get her alongside, and I wonder whether there'll be a double change with her and the captain Caroline Seger coming on to solidify that midfield for Sweden, to give those forwards, Blackstenius, Rolfo, Jakobsen, Aslani, the license to just go and do what they can to England's back line.
Well, there's plenty of Lionesses fans at home hoping that, I suppose, those changes aren't made or that Sweden can't find a way to get back in this, including Spurs assistant coach Vicky Jepson. My poor neighbours. I mean, I imagine there was quite some noise across the country when Beth Mead did find the back of the net. Former Lioness Faye White, Beth Mead, predator in the box. She shows her striker's instinct again. That is 6 in 5 games. Again, just quickly on her, popping up again when they really need her. Just clinical.
You know, she's frightening, isn't she? I mean, the fact that she has the awareness to kind of peel off the back four a little bit, give herself some space to just instinctually take that touch, turn, and then she, you know, she knows where the goal is, so she just needs to absolutely, she just smashes it into the net, and Hedvig Lindahl has no chance. And I just love that attitude, that mindset about her. She's flying, she's feeling confident, and yeah, I mean, it's really great to see.
Well, she's well on her way to that golden boot. No player has ever scored more goals at a single edition of the UEFA Women's European Championship than Beth Mead, with her 6 goals in 2022. That's level with Inka Grings back in 2009. Coming up, we're going to get some more from Callum Bardsley, from Juliet Ferrington as well, here at Bramall Lane. We're going to be checking in with our 6:06 team. That's Sam Quick and Clinton Morrison this evening. They're going to be wanting your calls post-match. As it stands, that will be 10 o'clock. But first of all, before we bring you the second half here on 5 Live Sport, we've got the news, and that's with Joe Hornby.
Listen on BBC Sounds. This is BBC Radio 5 Live.
The Ministry of Defence has proposed an independent review into how it handled allegations that the SAS executed unarmed civilians in Afghanistan. It comes after BBC Panorama revealed that one SAS unit was involved in 54 suspicious killings in one six-month tour in 2010-11. A spokesperson for the MOD said the review would be led by a senior judge. Tonight's TV Conservative leadership debate between Liz Truss and Rishi Sunak has been halted after Talk TV's presenter fainted live on air. The broadcaster apologised to viewers, saying that although Kate McCann was fine, the medical advice was not to continue. More than 40,000 workers from the RMT union, from Network Rail and 14 train operating companies will walk out tomorrow in a dispute over pay and conditions. About 80% of train services won't run. It's one of a number of rail strikes this summer. Nigel Harris from Rail Magazine says people will stop using trains if they continue.
What we've got now is a leisure-led railway. Those people do have a choice. And at the moment, they've got crowded, overcrowded trains with insufficient timetabling. And these people will not continue to choose the railway if it is rampantly unreliable or not running at all. So the urgency to get this sorted is crucial.
The International Monetary Fund has downgraded significantly its prediction for Britain's economic growth next year. It thinks the UK economy will grow by only half of 1%. That's the slowest rate in the G7 group of leading industrialised nations. Our global trade correspondent Darshini David says the high cost of oil and gas is hurting Britain in particular.
Even though it's the EU we know is particularly dependent on Russia when it comes to gas, when it comes to reliance on fossil fuels, the UK outstrips a lot of its neighbours. So 75% of our energy mix is fossil fuels at the moment. So that means that spike in prices that we're seeing on international markets impacts us disproportionately.
And the Environment Agency is urging people in England to use water wisely this summer. It's fallen short of predicting a drought. The Met Office says England has experienced the driest start to the year since 1976.
We all think we can do it. Pick a team to win a trophy, buy and sell players. I mean, how hard can it really be?
That is nowhere near the standards that we set collectively as a team.
Moment of Truth will challenge your assessment of whether you can really manage a football club by taking you to the beating heart of the fight for promotion to the Championship.
It just went kaboom.
If you lose 4 games, you'll get the sack.
These are the bits about football clubs that people don't see.
We take you on the ultimate journey of sporting pressure as Rotherham's Paul Warren and Oxford's Carl Robinson fight it out to change their collective stories forever.
The pressure's on winning is absolutely disgusting.
Moment of Truth. Listen first on BBC Sounds.
BBC 5 Live, Euro 2022, with Emma Saunders.
So England then halfway to the Euro 2022 final. They're a goal up here at Bramall Lane against Sweden. Beth Mead coming through, scoring her sixth of the tournament. This place erupted, as did many a living room, pub garden and fan zone across the country, I'm sure. Speaking of, there are thousands of supporters right now in Trafalgar Square watching on a big screen there. And here in Sheffield, there's also a fan park which we can head back to now. And touch base with Andy Giddings. How's it all going there, Andy?
Emma, thank you very much indeed. So welcome back to Devonshire Green. Those thousands of fans are still here, nestled in the deep dip of the crescent, watching the big screen TV. Well, Janet and Vicky were stood here, but Vicky, well, she's gone to the bar. Janet is still here. So look, 1-0, slender lead. How do you think it's going at halftime?
I feel quite confident about England, really. I think they'll probably cut loose a little bit more in the second half, hopefully get a goal after half time. It was a beautiful goal by Beth Mead, really impressive. I'm confident that they'll get through to the final.
And what a finish, tight, compact. It's her tournament, isn't it? She's the headline grabber.
Yeah, but I think actually England have got real strength in depth. They've got a huge squad. There's people sitting on the bench who I think we'll see in the second half. Jill Scott, Nikita Paris. They can certainly make an impact from the bench team. And I think that's what will take them all the way in this cup match and in the final probably, hopefully on Sunday.
Because in the first 10 or 15 minutes or so, the nerves were there, weren't they? Sweden hitting the woodwork.
I think it's not been that long since the previous match. It takes a while to recover. These girls are good athletes, but it's also a huge crowd at Bramall Lane. It's probably one of the biggest crowds. I don't know the stats on the numbers at Bramall Lane, but it will be full tonight. And there's a lot of noise going on, and there's probably quite a lot of, you know, this is a really big thing for women's sport, and there's a lot resting on England's shoulders, but I think they're strong enough to handle it.
So confidence here, Janet. Thank you very much indeed. Absolutely. Emma, back to you.
Yeah, some scenes of celebration there a little bit later on, as there will be across the country if England can hold on here and make it to the final of Euro 2022. Following the football tonight, if we do finish in normal time and it stays as it is, at 10 o'clock we will have 6:06 with Kenton Morrison and Sam Quirk, who at this rate will be hosting a bit of a party on the airwaves as well later. I mean, what a first half, guys.
Oh, brilliant first half, wasn't it, Clinton? We were cheering.
Yeah, we were cheering, to be fair. Brilliant goal from Beth Mead. I do think Sweden were the better team, though, in the first 15, 20 minutes. Epps had to make a couple of good saves and then they hit the bar. But once England got that goal, they looked the better team. And they didn't want half-time because they were pushing for that second goal.
Yeah, I know. It's going to be a brilliant second half. But we want to hear your thoughts. Those of you watching the game, whether you're travelling back from the game, the number's 08085 909 693. Whatever the result, get in touch. We want to talk to you about the result. Like you say, Emma, hopefully it will stay with England the lead and we'll have an England victory in normal time. But as I say, it's there's plenty to play in the next 45. Clinton, your thoughts on how it might go?
Yes, I don't think Sweden are not out of it, most definitely not. They look a threat up front. They're causing England a lot of problems. But I still think now they have to come out even more and there'll be space for England's players, in particular Heb, Mead and Ella White. And then if Russo comes on, she'll cause problems because she's been brilliant so far.
Yeah, it's going to be a brilliant game between two brilliant teams. But as I say, get your calls in at the end of the game. Book your slot now so you're guaranteed some airtime. The number again is 08085 909 693. And thanks very much, Emma, Izzy and Stephen.
Yeah, we're looking forward to linking up with you guys a little bit later. Hopefully, as we said there, celebrating the Lionesses making it to the Euro 2022 final. The Swedish players have already been sent back out. I can see Serena Wiegmann's made an appearance as well. So with that, we'll go pitch side once more before we head to our comms team. Juliet Farrington, any sign of any changes?
The England team are now making their way out. I'm just being attracted to the various banners around me. I've got one for Ellen White. Can I have your shirt, Lucy Brock? Can you sign my shirt? Now, that would be something. That's to my left. To my right, there's a banner. Please, can I have your shirt over there? So many flags of St. George. I think that fan is just welcome for anything. And then the fans behind me, Ella Toon and Lessie Russo, they were down here to my right-hand side when Beth Mead scored. And those two just leapt up so high. And the biggest smile, as big as that England goal that we had. You could see it from distance, freed from desire. That was the chance. And then obviously 6-5 now for Beth Mead. But the array of England shirts behind me through all the generations, the ages, everybody is here. And they will be wanting so much of the very same in the second half.
Yeah, the 30,000 here inside at Bramall Lane, I'm sure, ready to raise the roof once more. The Swedish players to our left in a cluster, just breaking off now. The Lionesses getting in position too. Just finally, Karen, more of the same for the Lionesses. Would you change anything tactically at this point? How important is the second goal?
I mean, the girls have grown in confidence, you know, with every moment of that that performance since they scored. So I would say more of the same. I was just admiring the goal. And that pass from Rach Daly into the ball, into Lauren Hemp, and you know, obviously the cross didn't come off, but the second cross did. So I would say, you know, maybe continue with the decisions, maybe like tighten things up a little bit, but ultimately, let's go.
Yeah, let's go indeed. The whistle has been blown. The second half is underway. England halfway there. Izzy Christensen, Stephen Warnock, Vicky Sparks, it's all yours.
Thanks, Emma. No changes for either side at halftime as Kira Walsh clears away for England. Sweden playing from left to right will have the throw just inside the England half. Playing in the yellow shirts, the dark shorts and the yellow socks. England in their all-white kit. Thumped up to the halfway line and Lauren Hemp will pick it up. Tries to feed it through to Ellen White. Only rolls through to the Sweden centre-half, Sten Branton. Hedvig Lindahl, the former Chelsea goalkeeper, can play it back to Magdalena Eriksson, who clears long over halfway. Intercepted by Lucy Bronze. Back in field now to Kira Walsh. England moving the ball with confidence and purpose early on as Rolfa, though, gets that interception on Bronze's pass and wins a throw over on the far side. So England with Earps in goal. The back four of Bronze, Bright, Williamson the captain and Daly. Ahead of them, Stanway and Walsh with Mead the goal scorer, Kirby and Hemp supporting White up top. The ball is all the way back with Sweden's Lindahl. Their back four of Ilicet, Sembrant, Eriksson and Glass. Ahead of them, Angeldahl, Aslani and Bjorn with Rolfa and Jakobsen supporting Blackstenius, who hit the bar at 0-0 in the first half. Up front, England in possession, midway through their own half. England, who are now less than a half of Football Plus at a time away from their first final since 2009 and only the third major tournament final in their history. They reached it at the European Championships twice. They're looking to reach it again as Lauren Hemp wins it on the left-hand side. Cut back into the penalty area. Excellent challenge by Hannah Glass on Beth Mead, who is coming to take that shot first time. It's behind for an England corner.
Oh, she does so well there, Hannah Glass, because she has to make sure that she steps in from that left-back position and gets the run of Beth Mead and make sure that she tracks her. But that's a really good start to the second half.
So corner to England. Mead will swing it in from the left-hand side. It's high. It's met by Bronze. Yeah! It's bounced all the way in. It's deceived Hedvig Lindahl. And Lucy Bronze runs away in celebration because inside the opening 3 minutes of this second half, England have breathing space against Sweden as they look to reach that first major final since 2009. England 2, Sweden 0.
Yeah, and she almost looked surprised because I don't think her header was an intended shot on target. It's for the second ball. She's headed it back across goal, looking for a runner to tap it in. But it's gone in herself and she's absolutely delighted with it. But hang on a minute, Vicky, what?
There's a VAR check for a potential offside. Now, Lauren Hemp might be the player they're looking at. Was she blocking the view of Lindahl? It doesn't get a touch on anyone else on the way through, but they will have a look at this VAR. Now, Sweden, before this match, were complaining about the VAR decisions that have gone against them in this tournament. They might be about to be reprieved here, because Esther Staberley is not letting Sweden take the kickoff. The goal given on the pitch, the score at 2-0, but is this about to be chalked off? Lucy Bronze's header. Serena Wiegmann stands on the edge of her technical area.
I think one of the things that they're also looking at is Lauren Hemp. Is she onside? Was it even an issue? Because there was a Swedish defender who was level. It's been given.
It stands. And we kick off. England 2 lead by 2-0 in this semi-final. Lucy
Lily Bronze's name is roared out by the announcer to this capacity crowd at Bramall Lane. And Hent now picks it up on the left-hand side for England. What a perfect start to this second half. Can it get even better? Cleared away by Angeldahl for Sweden, ahead of Kirby. And Sweden will come forward once more. Sliding challenge by Millie Bright, picked up by England's scorer of their second on the night, Lucy Bronze, here on Five Live and the World Service as Bright clears down towards halfway. Beth Mead challenged, Glass wins the throw. Glass is told not to take the throw because she's fouled Beth Mead. England have a throw on the far side.
Yeah, it's a really crucial moment, that VAR check. So crucial in the momentum of this game, which way it can swing. If it doesn't get given, the momentum just swings into Sweden's favour and they're buoyed by that. But as a result, we are going to see Carolyn Sager and Ritin Kanerid, the right winger for Sweden, because Peter Gerhardsen has to do something. He's got to respond. He's got to respond now if Sweden have any chance of getting themselves back into this.
Yeah, double change coming for Sweden. The fans at Bramall Lane are singing that song once again. And England are 2-0 up now as they look to take that final step towards Wembley. To Wembley it would take them, and then one more step to go. Lauren Hemp receives the ball on the edge of the penalty area, curls it in. Lindahl is there, very nervy punch in front of her own defender. Low punch, does get it out of the penalty area. The flag's gone up for offside on the far side anyway, but Izzy called it early on, and Karen Bardsley to my right is shaking her head. Lindahl, for all her experience, is not always the most convincing.
Yeah, she's not looked comfortable at all. And on this occasion against England, where she's had a lot more to do in that Sweden goal, she's not looked comfortable. She's really, really strange technique to come and clear that cross. Lauren Hemp's just whipped it into an area teasingly. And Linda, she's kind of like half punched it. It's just a weird situation anyway, and regardless, it's put her team under pressure and caused issue for her defence. But that effect that it has on your defence and the rest of your team isn't good, because when your goalkeeper is confident, it gives you that aura of confidence to move forward and trust that she's going to come and claim crosses. But she's looked anything but assuring tonight, for my opinion.
So the double change has been made by Sweden. Angeldahl of Manchester City and Sofia Jakobsen, the former Chelsea player, have come off. Johanna Ritting-Kanerid is on, as is Caroline Sager, the most capped player in Europe. It's her 233rd as Sweden come forward, ball into the area. Dangerous one. Oh, what a miss. What a miss by Ilestedt, drifting in at that near post. Mary Earps was beaten. How has she not got that on target?
Yeah, that's an exceptional ball over the top, and it's Ilestedt who's got herself into the box. I'm sorry, but if you have to score that. In fact, looking on the replay, Rachel Daly gets a touch and it takes it away from Ilestad, and so she can't connect with it properly. It's a really good bit of defending from Rachel Daly. But on that occasion, I said in the first half, Sweden haven't had enough numbers in the box, and they had four lining up there. Really good opportunity for them.
Yeah, good spot, Izzy. Really important touch there by Rachel Daly, and that is why Ilestad couldn't get the header on target. Close to 2-1 to England. Sweden pulling a goal back almost, but still 2-0 here on Five Live in the World Service as Mary Earps comes to the edge of her penalty area and claims. But the experience of Carolyn Sager, who was part of that side that beat England in the bronze medal match back at World Cup 2019, is going to be key. 37 years old now, such a pedigree in the women's game, her 13th major tournament for Sweden. But Sweden it is, who trail by 2-0. 8 minutes gone in this second half. And here is the England captain, Leah Williamson, stepping away brilliantly from Aslani. Still going, Williamson. Plays a lovely ball through. That's great distribution outside of the right boot. Forward to Kirby. Lays it off to Millie Bright. Sweden getting the yellow shirts back as England press forward. Here is the goal scorer of their second, Lucy Bronze. And now Stanway out to the right-hand side. And Beth Mead in field now to Kira Walsh. Bit of space, plays it into the area looking for White. Cleared away by Sembrant. Will be brought down by Ritting-Kanerid, but lost. And England pick it up once more, leading by 2-0. Here is Lauren Hemp, plays the ball into the area. Cleared away well by Sembrant. Powerful header, spins out to the left-hand side. And here is Fridolina Rolfer up against Lucy Bronze. Ball goes out of play. for a Sweden throw midway through their own half.
Yeah, it looks like Jonna Andersson's going to enter the fray after an illness, I believe. Looks like Sweden are going to go much more direct than they already have, and I think with Andersson they've got an attacking fullback to help get overloads in the wide areas, and I would not be too surprised if we do see Lena Hurtig, Sweden striker, on the bench. I can see a warming up down there on the right to come on as a result of Andersson. I think Peter Gerhardsen will just see if Andersson has an impact, and then I think if she's starting to get crosses in the box, I'd say Sweden, you know, want to be a threat, get Hurtig on as well. She's a threat in the box aerially.
England in possession. Kirby plays it back to Williamson. Yeah, she was a real doubt for this match. Jonna Andersson has been ill. Left Chelsea this summer, is going back to Sweden and joining Hammarby, but will give them an option down the flanks with Glass over on this right-hand side now. Illicit, the player to make way, as Magdalena Eriksson, under pressure from Beth Mead, plays it back to Hedvig Lindahl, and England just taking up those positions, holding that line of four as Sweden play it over the top, calmly done by Leah Williamson, and it's all the way back to Mary Earps as the camera phones and the lights dot around us, sprinkled like stars amongst the red and white England flags in the stands at Bramall Lane, as Sweden pick it up down the left-hand side. The delivery in, the glance header is just past the post as Mary Earps watches Black Stenius's header drift wide.
Well, there's the danger straight away. Andersson on the pitch, he gets a 2v1 situation down the left-hand side. Little dink cross, and Black Stenius couldn't quite generate the power on the header herself. It was a floated ball in, just stood up to her. She did well to get any connection on it. Just goes past the right-hand post of Mary Earps. But now we're going to see England respond with their own change.
And this is a player who has had an outstanding tournament. And she's yet to start. But she's scored 3 goals here. She's receiving a rousing ovation, not least from the player she's replacing, Ellen White. Big clenched double fist. And White smashes her palms down on the palms of her manager, Serena Friedman. Ellen White cares. Ellen White believes that the Lionesses could be heading to their first major final since 2009. 2-0 they lead Sweden. Alessia Russo is on.
Yeah, it's the right thing as well, Vicky, to bring on Russo just to stretch that back line, already having an impact.
Here she goes down the right hand side, the green booted Manchester United player. Ball into the area, what a ball! Oh, Hemp! She's missed it from 3 yards off the bar. What a miss from Lauren Hemp. Almost the immediate impact from Alessia Russo. That should have been 3-0 England. That should have been England well on their way to Wembley.
How is that not 3-0? It's harder to miss. Stephen.
I just think she leans back, and I think she just opens a foot up ever so slightly too much. I think the pace on the ball from Russo is perfect because it takes the defender out the equation. But it's one of those moments where you think, I've scored. You just, that lack of concentration at the end, that should have been game, set and match.
She doesn't even need to connect with it. She just needs to slide and let it hit her body, and it's gone in.
The look of confusion on your face, Izzy Christensen, is priceless.
I couldn't believe, technically.
2-0.
Technically one of the most gifted players I've ever seen in Lauren Hemp.
She's on the ball here, clears it out of play. Let's head back to Jules down pitch side. Jules.
Yeah, I mean, you could hear that ball clatter off the crossbar. How on earth did Hemp miss that? We don't know, but a lot of love for Alessia Russo behind me, especially off the fans. And when she came on to replace Ellen White, there was lots of Russo, Russo. And yeah, they've been calling for her throughout this match, and now they have their wish with her being on.
Thanks, Jules. Down pitch side for us at Bramall Lane. 13 minutes played in the second half of this semi-final. England 2, Sweden 0, and that's a short pass back. Hedvig Lindahl has to come out so quickly to get there ahead of Alessia Russo. Does so. Glass will head it on this right-hand side for Sweden. Kira Walsh muscled out of it, and that's good play by Ritin Kanarid. Just plays it off Walsh, and it's a throw to Sweden.
Yeah, the introduction of Russo, I tell you what, it's already scared Sweden. The back line, I've already been aware of the threat that she poses in behind, and she's
yeah, she's definitely going to scare them, and it just give England that edge.
Cleared away by Leah Williamson to Bjorna Andersson on the halfway line for Sweden. England 2, Sweden 0 on 5 Live in the World Service. A reminder, you can watch this match on BBC One. You have the option to select our commentary as well if you do that via the iPlayer, the BBC Sport website, or the red button. It's Lucy Bronze, England's scorer of the second goal early in this second half, heads the ball away. It's brought down by Sweden. We'll pick it up on the left-hand side in the field now to the experienced Caroline Sager. Forward now to Aslani, who's been quiet in this second half. I think that's the first time I've mentioned Aslani's name in the last 10 minutes or so, and that is very, very good news for England, because she is a real danger woman, the Olympic silver medalist. Here is Rittin Kanerids, plays it back all the way into her own half, and Sweden will build down the right.
Love to know, Stephen, what distance Aslani covers in a game, because she's everywhere, offensively so impactful, but also defensively as well, runs everywhere.
England have given the ball away midway through their own half. Here is Rittin Kanerids, just backheeled it inadvertently, and Rachel Daly will bring it away, but it's a poor ball though. Rittin Kanerids wins it back, cleared away by England, and Rachel Daly just slipped there, lifts away, but is already walking freely, and it's a throw to Sweden, taken quickly as they have to. They're trailing by 2-0. Leah Williamson trying to shepherd this out. She's fouled by Aslani, and it will be a free kick to England deep in their own territory.
There's a lot of questions before the game about the team selection. I have to say, the players who were questioned before the game have arguably been England's star performers. Rachel Daly at left back's been outstanding. You look at Georgia Stanway, Frank Kirby in midfield, they have been brilliant so far.
Here comes Kirby once more, trying to dink it through to Lauren Hemp, cleared away by Hedvig Lindahl up to the halfway line. England 2, Sweden 0. Heavy challenge by Kirby and Daly between them. Yields a free kick for Natalie Bjorn and Sweden. You've gone in on her like that in training, is he, at Everton?
Nah. She can't get near me. We would never come across each other like that in training. No, I'm joking. No, I hope she's okay, as she is.
Sweden in possession. Here is Chelsea captain Magdalena Eriksson. Fizzes it out to the left-hand side, and Jonna Andersson. The field to Sager was closed down quickly. Eriksson steps up, makes sure England can't counter, but now they almost steal it over on that far side. Throw to Sweden. One thing I've noticed, in terms of the wing player of England, Mead has almost exclusively stayed on the right and Hemp stayed on the left, which is a bit of a change for England. They have swapped it around in this tournament so far, but as Sweden try and work it down the left-hand side, it is their more natural position. Sweden have done well here, down towards the byline, and they win a corner.
Such good recovery from Kira Walsh, spotting that Lucy Bronze has been beaten in that right-back position. Can she get across? Can she help her teammates out? Now it's concentration, it's organisation. Do not concede a goal from a set piece.
England 2, Sweden 0. Sweden with the corner. The former Manchester City player, Kosovari Aslani, stands over it, swings it towards that crowded six-yard box, side netting, poor delivery from Aslani.
Yeah, not expected from Kosovar Aslani. That set piece, it's not even made the box, it's hit the side netting. You know, the state of the game.
We'll take that.
We'll take it, absolutely, but yeah, she needs to do better. Get the ball in the box for your team.
Stephen Warnock and Izzy Christensen here with us on 5 Live in the World Service as Maria plays it out to the left-hand side. Leah Williamson in possession, up towards halfway. Headed forward by Sweden though. Good interception by Bjorn of Everton, and now in field to Sager, who in the end manages to step away from Georgia Stanway, but she's been hassled and harried, and it's a loose touch. Sembrant will play it forward though. Headed down by Blackstenius. Rittin Kanerid will pick it up, edge of the penalty area. She's done really well here, gets the shot away. Blocked by England and Leah Williamson, picked up by Blackstenius once more. That's brilliant. Brilliant defending from the England captain, Leah Williamson, just steals it away from her Arsenal teammate, Blackstenius, and it's cleared away to Magdalena Eriksson inside her own half.
Just on the ropes a little bit, England here, and just backs against the wall, but keep your shape, be organised, make it difficult, know you can counter-attack. I think that's the big thing, is that you know you've got substitutes to come on the pitch later on as well.
Glass has done well down the right, but Hemp's done better. Little back heel, sends it out for a Sweden throw. England with this 2-goal advantage to protect. 18 and a half minutes gone in this second half. Glass plays the ball in, sliding block by Hemp.
now for a Sweden throw.
Yeah, defensive duties from Lauren Hemps. Anything to stop the cross, knowing full well Sweden are good. Aslani getting out of that again.
Lovely work by Aslani down to the byline. Ball across, corner. Will the delivery be better this time?
Well, certainly hope so. But what I'd have to say is the work rate of the England players, the covering, they're knowing that they've been beaten. The next one's there to back them up. This is a real team effort tonight. It's been absolutely brilliant so far.
So Aslani will leave this one for Jonna Andersson, former Chelsea fullback. Again, the six-yard box is packed with yellow shirts dotted around the white tops of England. As Andersson swings the ball in, Earps is underneath it, she wasn't sure, it's a scramble, it's off the line, and it's away just by Rachel Daly. Back out to Andersson, danger still alive here, England have to hold firm, ball back in, Eriksen was up there, misses the header, sent back in again, needed by... What a save by Mary Earps!
Wow.
England's number one, denying Stina Blackstenius with an absolutely marvellous stop. It's a Sweden corner. It should have been a Sweden goal back, but for the brilliance of Mary Earps.
Well, I've just watched two former England number ones high-five each other in Karen Bardsley. Oh, my word. I mean, that is just phenomenal. What a save. It's... Wow.
I think it was Rachel Brown finishing the other one, because I'm certainly not a former England number one. I've not got the height, Stephen.
I was just in shock. What a save.
And the irony is, I mean, Blackstenius, we need to see a replay, but it almost comes off her knee. So whether she's able to control it with that awkwardness, good from Blackstenius. Amazing from Earps as the corner is swung in, near post. They're all appealing. It's another Sweden corner. England still under the cosh, but a save like that can do wonders. So Sweden with another corner. England 2, Sweden 0. Here they come once more, swung in. It's powerfully headed away by Williamson on the edge of the six-yard box. Sweden will pick it up again with Andersson. Sent back in to the penalty area by Glass. It's flicked on. Earps is there. And that is a good claim. She had Blackstenius and Aslani right on her there, Mary Earps. And she drops to the ground. And it is still England 2, Sweden 0 midway through the second half.
Big, big spell of pressure for Sweden. England absorb it like a sponge. And Mary Earps taking full control of the situation. That save was up there with saves of the tournament, and we've seen some good ones, by the way. Blackstenius doesn't even mean to connect with it with a knee. I think it's a miss.
Miscue here by Hannah Glass outside her own penalty area. Here goes Lauren Hemp. She's forced wide. It's good recovery by Hannah Glass, but it's better by Hemp. She turns and field. She's still going. Hemp pulls it across. Oh, it's just ahead of Russo, who was crowded out of it by Eriksen and Sager. Back in by England from the right-hand side. Poor delivery over the heads of everyone, but will be picked up once more by Rachel Daly. Under pressure, we'll send it back to the halfway end, Leah Williamson. There are more goals in this game as England come forward again. Down the left-hand side, nice little 1-2 between Kirby and Hemp. Kirby down to the byline, just slows the play, pulls it back to Hemp, looking for options, pulls it back now to Kira Walsh, and Walsh will go all the way back to Rachel Daly. And England just trying to get a little bit of control of this game and make sure it's not so frenetic. And by control, they look dangerous going forward, so does Sweden, but England don't need to force it. They have the two-goal advantage as Walsh does a 360, slides it in, brilliant ball, Kirby in the penalty area, pulls it back, must be brilliant save, Lindahl from Russo. Russo back here! What a goal! What a goal! Valencia Russo, the cheekiest back heel you will ever see, and it could well have sent England to Wembley. It's audacious, it's outstanding, it's England 3, Sweden 0!
Wow, what a goal! This is absolutely outrageous. I mean, she should score the first one. It's lovely play down the left-hand side. It's Fran Kirby who gets in. She picks out Alessia Russo. Russo fires it, saved by the keeper. And as it comes out, she's running towards the corner flag, her back to goal. She just backheels it through the legs of Lindahl. One of the best goals you will see. Outrageous.
She's not just nutmeg Lindahl. She's nutmeg Andersson as well. It's the double nutmeg. And do you know what? The first chance that she had, she was like, nah, that's too easy. I'm going to have my back to goal.
and I'm going to backheel it through two Swedish people's legs, and I'm going to hit the back of the target, and I am 99.9% going to send my country to Wembley.
It's gorgeous. It's gigantic in the course of this game as Sweden come forward and drive from the edge of the area. And when they showed that on the replay here, the entire capacity crowd here at Bramall Lane, I mean, there was just an ooh of disbelief. Jules is down pitch side. Jules, you must have had a fabulous goal. What a piece of skill.
I'm not gonna lie about this. When we saw her do it, the back heel, we just knew from our vantage point it was going in because we are so close to seeing what she just did. That was absolutely outrageous. And behind me, the fan club, the Alessia Russo fan club, went absolutely wild.
Really on Sweden's backs now as Lauren Hedt just miscontrols inside the penalty area, and Lindahl gathers, and the crowd at Bramall Lane, well, you can tell what they believe this summer. England 3-0 Sweden. And it's the style of that goal as well. I mean, if you're an opponent, never mind a goalkeeper, if you're that entire Sweden team and you see that goal go in, I mean, it is the most demoralising way to concede, because it is such a fabulous piece of skill, and it just saps the energy right out of you.
It's demoralising. England were turning it on anyway, but to score a backheel goal like that in a European Championship semi-final against a team who released a document of how to beat them, I'm sorry, but if that's not taking the mickey, I don't know what is.
Ball over the top, looking for Russo once more over the halfway line. She won't get there, and Sweden will gather. 20 minutes plus out of time to play. England 3-0 Sweden. England, who have not conceded more than once in a match in their 18 games under Serena Wiegmann. 20 minutes to play, Stephen, but the atmosphere in here, the belief in here, it's sky high.
Yeah, it is, but let's not forget the two key moments of the game. Mary Earps, we're going to talk about everyone else on the pitch bar her because of what they've done going forward. She has contributed the two biggest moments in the game. At 0-0 in 45 seconds, she makes an incredible save. And at 2-0, when Sweden have got England on the back foot and they're really pressing them, she comes up with an absolute, arguably, save of the tournament so far. And you're looking at that saying, that's the job of the goalkeeper. The concentration levels, that is what they bring to the team.
Well, the cheer is Russo, Russo. Esther Stowley is coming over to Rachel Daly, having a word with her. Not too sure what that's about, because Daly certainly wasn't dawdling as she prepares to take this throw for England. And Fran Kirby will send it back to Millie Bright. England 3-0 Sweden. Here on 5 Live in the World Service, and we have seen one of the goals of the tournament, one of the best goals I've ever seen live from Alessia Russo. Back heel to make it 3-0. Ball goes out of play, and Sweden, well, they look as though they're running out of ideas here. England have really turned it on, and let's not forget England, who before Beth Mead scored 11 minutes before half time, had been second best. Sweden have been playing very well. Can Aslani get them going again? Can she make it interesting from a Sweden point of view? The Lionesses won't care a bit if she doesn't. The ball is given away and Hemp will play it forwards. Sagar's interception. Hannah Glass shields the ball from Lauren Hemp and will pick it up once more. Sagar square to Bjorn and all the way back to Eriksson. Intercepted. Here England go again. Bjorn has committed the foul in the centre circle, and this will be a yellow card.
Yeah, it's a blatant yellow card from Natalie Bjorn, pulling down Stanway as she broke free in that midfield area. But just going back to that previous sideways pass from Aslani into the path of what she thought was going to Ritten Kanerid, the right winger running onto it. The pass was just behind her, so she had to check, and it gave Lauren Hemp, whose recovery was exceptional, even at 3-0 up and 73 minutes gone. That, I think, just epitomises where both of these teams are at in this tournament. Lauren Hemp's desire to get back for the team and Sweden's just lack of execution.
Aslani is closing down. Ball is out of play from England for a Sweden throw. Hannah Glass will come over to take it.
The attendance is announced inside Bramall Lane, just below capacity in the stands. But they roar their approval, 28,624. And that little knot of Sweden fans away to our right, around 1,500 of them here in Sheffield this evening. The yellow flags are not waving. The supporters are sitting glum and silent because their side are trailing by 3-0 in this Women's European Championship semi-final here on BBC Radio 5 Live in the World Service. Russo, who has scored that beautiful back heel, holds on to the ball for England. Back now to the left-hand side and Stanway. Lovely interchange of passes from Williamson and Stanway. England playing with such confidence. 3-0. Pulled ball forward by Kirby though. Kemp won't reach it. And here is Whitting Kanarid. Plays the ball forward looking for Blackstenius. All the way through to Mary Earps.
I wonder at what point Serena Beekman thinks, okay, I don't want to lose certain players for the final now. And is there an opportunity to make changes to rest players ready for that final? England should be home and dry. At 3-0, with what, 15 minutes to go, the game should be done. So, and the quality of substitutes that she's got at her disposal should be able to see this game out.
Almost a mix-up at the back from England, though, just as you say that, Stephen. Mary Earps just about getting distance on the clearance in the end, and it spins out for an England throw. Final roll of the dice for Sweden, and it's the change that Izzy predicted. The Juventus striker Lena Hurtig, one of those coming on. Stina Blackstenius of Arsenal is departing, and she's been quieter over the last 10-15 minutes, having looked so dangerous and hit the bar in the first half, Izzy.
Yeah, and it's obviously a shame to see a player of her quality leaving the pitch. She's been such an exciting player to watch, even at times when Sweden haven't been playing well. She's always a threat, and she always gives the fans in the stands that moment to stand up and think that something exciting is going to happen. And yet on comes Lena Hurtig, who's a very different profile of striker.
England looking to get through the middle again. Kirby shoots from distance. Lindahl makes the save, but she doesn't get enough on it. And England are going to Wembley. England are through to their third major final in their history. What a goal. Once again, Lindahl did her best, but she couldn't keep it out. And England are sweeping away Sweden in the semi-finals. They lead by 4-0. Jules, you're down pitch side and the place has erupted.
The place is on its feet. All the banners, all the goals, all the horns, all the applause, all the noise. Fran Kirby, can I just say as well, she beat me at hoops earlier on this week in the media session. But what a strike that was. Unbelievable as the fans now get back to their seats. I don't think they're expecting as many goals as they have seen tonight. And all of them have been absolute class.
You know what? The strike isn't that good. It's the idea to do it and to pull it off. And me and Stephen, between us, Stephen called it in the first half. Lindahl was off her line. Try the chip. Try the lob. And Frank Kirby's obviously got hold of this five live coverage from the first half at half time. She's listened to Stephen Warnock and she's like, hang on, he's right. I'm going to do that in the second half. And she's done that. She's almost executed it, but Lindahl's got her fingertips to it. And listen, I'm not a goalkeeping coach, but Lindahl probably should have done better. But it's the idea of Frank Kirby, and off Lindahl's fingertips into the back of the net.
What we've seen from both players, Alessia Russo with her finish, the back heel, and Frank Kirby with that chip, is players with sky-high confidence, who are willing to try things, who believe in what they're trying to do, and two great execution goals.
It's her last action of the game. It could be an action that puts the seal on England's progression through to the European Championship final. And she is replaced by Ella Toon, the hero of the quarterfinal in normal time. Georgia Stanway, of course, the hero in extra time. Big double high five with Serena Beekman. Big roar of toon all around Bramall Lane. And this is it, isn't it? I mean, Sweden must be thinking,
just blow the final whistle now, because Toon is another player that off the bench has been devastating for England in this tournament.
Still 12 minutes left, Vicky, and this could get quite embarrassing for Sweden.
Whitting Kanarids plays it down the left, looking for the run of Rolfa. Taking on Lucy Bronze, still going, ball into the area, and Mary Earps claims so well. And you're totally right, Stephen, the point you made 10 minutes or so ago. People will look at the goals that have been scored, the delicious Russo back heel. But in the opening minute and at 2-0, Mary Earps has made two saves that have done as much to cement England's place in the final as the four goals.
Yeah, and what that does for the defenders as well, it breeds confidence to them to know that they've got that brick wall behind them, that when called upon, she can make big saves at vital times.
Ball forward from Ella Toon over the head of Lauren Hemp, out for a Sweden throw. England 4, Sweden 0, approaching the final 10 minutes.
In the midst of this euphoria that's going on inside Bramall Lane, by the way, I want to just add in a tactical detail which I think Stephen called early on, that the game in midfield will be won and lost. England have been so smart with the positioning of the number 10. Ella Toon has just done exactly what Frank Kirby's done all game. And Leah Williamson's got that range just to dink it over the midfield pressing line into the number 10's feet.
Oh, it's gorgeous by Georgia Stanway. Nutmeg on Rolfa in the centre of the park, and now Lucy Bronze down the right hand side. Could this get even better for England? Here is Ella Toon, ball into the area, looking for Russo. Oh, it's a miscue from Natalie Bjorn, and goes behind for a corner, and that could have gone anywhere.
It's an excellent ball in from Toon. She's trying to be a little bit too precise in picking out her teammate Russo. As we know, them picking each other out normally results in one thing, and that's a goal. But it's caused Natalie Bjorn to make a big decision just inside her own 6-yard line. And the clearance could have gone anywhere, but it's just the quality of the ball into a good area that's caused the confusion.
So corner to be taken by Beth Mead for England over on this left-hand side. Standing ovation for the Arsenal player who got things underway for England in the first half, who broke the Sweden momentum. And England are breaking Swedish hearts in Sheffield tonight. Mead's delivery, it's fierce. It's headed towards the centre of the penalty area, cleared away by Sweden. Millie Bright will chest it down, and Toon very wisely, very calmly, goes back to Kira Walsh in the centre circle. Now out to the right-hand side, and Lucy Bronze. Bronze plays it forward. Clearance by Bjorn right into the face of Lauren Hemp, who goes down. It's a painful one for Hemp. Bjorn brings the ball down. Esther Stauberly has stopped play just to make sure that Lauren Hemp is all right. But this England performance at this tournament, I mean, getting through against Spain in extra time, they put us all through the ringer. But we had the 8-0 against Norway, 5-0 against Northern Ireland, the 1-0 against Austria in the opener in front of a new record crowd for a Women's Euros at Old Trafford. And now 4-0 against Sweden. They're just one off Germany in terms of a side scoring the most goals at a single edition of a Women's Euros. And we're not even at the final yet, but England will be there.
Not bad. Not bad, is it? But the only thing that we'll say is win it. We'll only judge this team on winning it, because that's what we believe that they're capable of doing. We looked at the Spain game and we looked at this game and said these are very, very tough games. We knew the quality of both oppositions. Now, you say we got put through the ringer against Spain. They did at times and they suffered a little bit, but they still believed and found a way to win it.
Emotionally.
Oh, sorry. But you look at this game and, okay, for the first 10, 15 minutes they weathered the storm. They've dominated this game after that. That tweak in midfield, it's changed the game completely. That is credit to the manager.
Do you know what I think as well? All those score lines that you listed off, Vicky, throughout the tournament so far, I guarantee there'll be a few players in that squad, and the most disappointing thing about it is they conceded a goal against Spain. And that just gives you an idea of the mentality of this team, and in particular the player I'm talking about, I know for a fact, is Lucy Bronze. I know she will be fuming they conceded against Spain.
Cleared away by Millie Bright, England 4, Sweden 0. If they go on and win it, will she be able to get over that disappointment?
Oh, you know, she'll
it'll make up for it, just.
Yeah,
just.
Of course. But that's just the type of, you know, mentality that she's got as an athlete. striving for best all the time.
Here comes Sweden over the halfway line, picked up now by the substitutes. Bennison cleared away by England over the halfway line and knocked around by Sweden at the back. But Sweden, the Olympic silver medalists, who haven't won a trophy since 1984 when they beat England in the finals of the European Championship. That wait is going on. Will it end finally for the Lionesses as they come forward once again, leading by 4-0. Here is Beth Mead, little miscontrol, and Sweden will pick it up. Beth Mead, incidentally, who is now England's all-time leading goal scorer at a Women's Euros, overtaking Jodie Taylor. Heavy challenge on the halfway line, and Georgia Stanway is called over, and it's a yellow card for Stanway. And that's what you were saying earlier, Stephen. I was going to say, you know, this is the sort of match they're playing so well, they won't want to come off, but you would hate a player to get a red card or an injury, and it's that Serena Wiegmann's got to balance.
Yeah, and I think we're going to see a host of changes, and hopefully Georgia Stanway is one of those players who leaves the
pitch
now.
She will be now, I think. Yeah.
I think she will, just because of that yellow card. But
really bad challenge.
I mean, her performance has been, wow, really, really impressive.
So, free kick to Sweden, who trail by 4-0. Ball to the edge of the area, header down, Rolfer almost latches onto it, will pick it up, forced towards the edge of the penalty area, left-hand side, Lucy Bronze is there, she doesn't want to concede, you can see it, Lucy Bronze, ball is dinked in, powerfully away by Bright. Oh, was that a foul on the edge of the area? Sweden and Sega didn't really appeal for it, they have the ball on the right-hand side now with Ritin Kanarid. England have to be careful here, can't go diving in, ball is pulled back, Russo back there defending, no nonsense. Out of play for Sweden throw, and here comes the double change for England. Beth Mead, who is leading those charts for the golden boot. She's two ahead of Germany's Alexandra Popp now. Germany against France, the second semi-final. Who will it be playing England in the final? Because it will be England. They lead by 4-0. There's 4 minutes plus added time to play. Join us for commentary of Germany-France tomorrow night on Five Live. 8 o'clock kickoff. You can watch that on the BBC as well. That's going to be a cracker. Chloe Kelly is on. Georgia Stanway is coming off. No surprise there after picking up that yellow card. And Jill Scott will replace her, and Alex Greenwood waits as well. But what a luxury for Serena Wiegmann to be able to make these changes, to rest players, to make sure Stanway doesn't get herself sent off at the end of the semi-final as Greenwood prepares to come on for Rachel Daly.
Yeah, it's a massive luxury, Vicky. She's utilising the squad, and there seems to be a consistent pattern of the players that she's using. And I think all the substitutions, they're not sentimental at all. They're the correct substitutions. As Stephen was saying, at Georgia Stanway, she just got herself yellow carded. I kind of imagine she was perhaps to give way anyway to Jill Scott, regardless of that yellow card, but it probably affirmed it. Alex Greenwood, we saw her come on in the Spain game, made an impact. And you know, the mentality of Serena Wiegmann and what she's instilled in these players is the level of performance. And she will not want this level of performance to drop, even for this closing 5 or 6 minutes and whatever extra time that we do have. And that's a winning mentality.
Sweden give away a free kick on the edge of their own penalty area. And Mary Earps trots over to take it. England 4-0 in the dying stages of this Women's Euro semi-final here on Five Live.
Been such a professional performance. Everyone who's entered the pitch has understood and watched intensely what the position is, what the role is when they come onto the pitch, and they've executed it so well. But you have to give credit again to the manager, Serena Wiegmann. Tactically aware, substitutions at the right time, not changing the team because she believed in it, and she's got everything she wanted and everything that we've seen so far. The starting 11 do so well, but then we see the impact of the substitutions. She's getting it right so far.
It's going to be the same team for the final, isn't it? I can't see her changing it.
Could many complain?
I don't think so. And they're singing it again at Bramall Lane as Chloe Kelly off the bench turns and drives towards the Sweden penalty area. Here is Jill Scott, lays it out to the right-hand side, and Lauren Hemp as England will just knock it around now with Lucy Bronze, cuts in field and turns away from the pressure all the way back to Millie Bright and out to Leah Williamson now. England are heading through to their first major final since Euro 2009. Is this to be the year that they end that wait
for a major trophy. They've never won one in Lionesses history. This will be only the third final in their history. All of them have come at the European Championships. Serena Wiegmann did it on home soil with the Netherlands 5 years ago. Is she to lead the Lionesses to victory on home soil? We'll find out on Sunday, the 31st of July, this Sunday at Wembley, 5 o'clock kickoff. Join us on 5 Live, and of course you can watch on BBC One as well. Sweden played the ball away from their own penalty area. England 4, Sweden 0 on 5 Live in the World Service. Ball played forward looking for Hurtig. Pete Bright gets the foot in. Free kick given away to Sweden just inside their own half. England reaching the final is huge, but the manner in which they've done it, and the two knockout games in particular, we've seen resilience against Spain when there were 6 minutes plus added time from going out and they came through. We've seen a brilliant performance, particularly in the second half and the final 55 minutes, you could say, of this match since Beth Mead's goal. But what it does for this side, they're showing they've got different ways to win. And whether it's Germany or whether it's France, that is going to be a huge test. Germany, eight-time European champions. France ranked third in the world, looking to win their first major trophy. Mentally, this England team have gained so much from these knockout stages, and it might not be over yet as Toon feeds Russo. Back to Toon, 25 yards out, plays it out to the right-hand side. Here goes Lauren Hemp, might go for the curler, goes for the cross instead. Russo is in there, oh, it's just past the post. Alessia Russo was there, Natalie Bjorn as well, but it's flicked past the post, it stays at 4-0, we're into 3 minutes of added time.
Yeah, and just seeing a really rare sight on the pitch that I've not seen yet this tournament very much, and Kira Walsh didn't complete a pass. It was, she tried the switch of play over the top of Magdalena Eriksson for the run of Lauren Hemp, but mis-executed it, and gosh, really poor from Kira. I'm joking. She's been outstanding. Absolutely outstanding.
She's on the ball once more. Lucy Bronze has just fired it into Walsh's head. I'm not sure she'll be too pleased with that, particularly if it leads to a Sweden consolation. Ritin Kanarid into the penalty area. Here is Hurtig. Dinks it back. Ritin Kanarid will pick it up, but she's forced away from the England box. And Bramall Lane is poised to celebrate in Sheffield here. We've 2 minutes of added time to play. England 4, Sweden 0 as Lauren Hemp makes the interception and she's off down the right-hand side. Russo's through the centre. She's screaming for it. Hemp lays it off instead to Kira Walsh. Lovely turn back. She's tripped. Free kick England. That's better from Kira Walsh.
No, that was class from Kira. She's just, you know, you think she's going to play forward and she just croaks it in between two players and just checks back and takes a... Oh, just, yeah, brilliant.
What does Lauren Hemp eat for dinner? Wow, the energy levels. Oh my word. She has not stopped running all night at full pelt.
Laid off by Ella Toon. Chloe Kelly will go for goal. Lindahl's right behind it. 30 yards out. Would have been special. 90 seconds to play. Get your calls in for 606 Lionesses fans. 08085 909 693. England are heading to Wembley. England are heading to their first major final since 2009. Forward now to Ella Toon, midway through the Sweden half, lays it off, Walsh won't pick it up, and here is Hurtig. Can Sweden find a consolation, scant consolation it will be, as Sagar, who hasn't quite been up with the pace of the game since coming on, is well pressured by Russo. Sweden will retain possession, played forward now to Aslani, lays it off to Glass, down this right-hand side, the ball in is watched all the way by Mary Earps. England 4, Sweden 0 into the final 45 seconds of added time.
On the night, Vicky, and every match so far in this tournament, bar the Spain games at time, England have been better than the opposition in every single department. Defensively, offensively, player for player, 1v1 defending, attacking, dribbling, they've been picking up second balls. Mary Earps has been outstanding in goal for England. So much confidence. Just think that's why England are where they are. They've just been better than everybody in every single department.
Eriksson clears the ball away for Sweden. Seconds left to play. Esther Stavely puts the whistle to her lips. Wembley awaits for the Lionesses. They are through to their first major final since 2009. The first major final since 2009. What a moment it is for these players.
They have swept Sweden away in this semi-final here in Sheffield. 4-0 winners. And is this to be the year that the Lionesses finally end their wait for a major trophy? England 4, Sweden 0. Izzy Christensen, it's been so positive for England this evening, and they've done it. They're through to Wembley.
You know what, Vicky, they've just been at such a high level individually. Everybody has performed at a 7 and 8 plus out of 10. There hasn't been one player on that park who hasn't performed. And if they have had a dip, somebody else has dragged them through, or Serena Wiegman's made a change and somebody else has come on and had an impact and lifted the level back up. I just think, like, this is so, so special what they're achieving right now. And all I can see on the pitch is humility. And that is something so special, something so English about us as people, is even when we're so successful, we bring it right back down to earth and we remember who we are and what we've done. And the atmosphere inside Bramall Lane tonight has been electric. It's been such a good thing to be part of. And Stephen, what a night.
Wow. I mean, there was nerves before the game. We talked about if both teams go toe-to-toe, who comes out on top. We said it might be a draw, it might be tight, it might go to penalties. England have just showed what a team they are. A togetherness, a real pride about themselves to perform at the highest level. And this has just been one of the best performances I've seen from them since Serena Wiegman's come in. She's tried to instill little beliefs in them, tactical awareness, understanding. But what she's given every single player in this squad, and you cannot buy, you cannot train, is confidence. The confidence she has instilled into these players is phenomenal.
And that's it, isn't it, Izzy? That is what we saw from this match, where again, England were tested in the first half an hour, the first 35 minutes. We again have to mention two key saves at key moments from Mary Earps. But overall, I mean, the Lionesses were just far too good for a side that are ranked second in the world to England's eighth, that won a silver medal at the Olympics last summer and only lost that final on penalties. But we're seeing this England team grow through this tournament, grow under Serena Wiegman. 11 wins in a row now, that extends a national record. 19 games unbeaten, that extends a national record. And that is so important going into this final at Wembley. England's third major final in their history. We'll be heading down to Juliet Ferrington pitch side, where the party has started, Jules.
Oh, the party is well and truly underway. They do like a bit of Dua Lipa when it comes to England. I think I've got used to this playlist now, so I think I know what's going to come, and I think I know what's going to come after that. Maybe a little bit of Status Quo will be in there. Freed from Desire will be in there as well. Just looking at Serena Wiegman, she is hugging every single member of her staff, her technical staff. And what usually happens now is they get themselves into a huddle, although I can see Millie Bright, she's ready to lift off. And they get themselves in a little bit of a huddle. Things are said amongst them as players, and then they will go and do their lap of appreciation. If my mic was long enough, I would try and speak to some of the fans alongside me. But there's a lot of dad dancing going on. There's a lot of applause going on. There's a lot of, can I have your shirt going on? Lots of requests for Lucy Bronze, Leah Williamson. The Ellen White has popped up again. And I can see Millie Bright in the thick of it with Mary Earp. So they will make their way around, I am sure. And then I will make my way into the tunnel and we'll try and speak to some of these players who are through to the final of the Euros for 2022, Vicky.
Yes, the semi-final curse is over for England. 2015 at the World Cup, they fell in the last four. Euro 2017, they fell in the last four. The World Cup in 2019, they fell in the last four. But 2022, at these home Euros, they have not fallen in the last four. They are through to Wembley as the players in a circle start to bounce and jump and celebrate. The arms are flying in the air. Mary Earps, one of those breaking away, applauding as the red and white flags wave all around us. The party is going to go on for some time here at Bramall Lane, and then it will gear up
for Sunday, the final of the European Championship, England will play either Germany or France. But England will be there for the first time since 2009, the third time in their history. Can they go that final step and win their first major trophy? 4-0, it finishes against Sweden in Sheffield.
Yep, another sweet, sweet victory. You know what comes with that. Cue the music. Sweet Caroline is about to be belted out here at Bramall Lane. How much fun is this? These Lionesses, they are such a joy. It was this time last year, of course, the men's reached the same stage of the Euros. But Izzy, there's something different about this, isn't there?
Yeah, and you had to come to me as it's going to break into chorus. I don't know what to do, whether to carry on speaking or dance or sing. Or I don't know what to do.
Is that arm reaching out?
I'm reaching out.
Are you?
Yeah.
Listen to that. Assure you of that. The scene's out there now. There's many young Lioness fans here inside the stadium this evening, but their parents thankfully let them stay behind a little later and take it all in, because this really is a night to remember. Karen, as a former England goalkeeper yourself, you only recently retired, this must make you quite emotional, doesn't it? You know these girls professionally, but personally as well. And to see you now on the cusp of what they might achieve.
I'm buzzing. Like, I'm so happy for these girls. Like, I am genuinely struggling to find the words to express, like, how amazing this feeling is. Like, to come so agonizingly close over the years and to finally see them to be able to do it and embrace the moment and just see them, like, show their pure happiness and joy. It's incredible.
Beth Mead has just been doing the pitch side interview. She has sprinted back over to the corner of the pitch. I mean, she's been running around all night, but she doesn't want to miss out on these celebrations. And this is it. I mean, we know that England, they'll enjoy the moment. They'll focus then on Wembley. That's what they do under Serena Wiegmann. It's what they've done all tournament. But they have to use this energy. They have to absorb it. They have to bring every ounce of this belief and excitement and confidence and passion and propel that into the final.
I think one of the things I'd love to say and speak about, this is how you bring the women's game to the forefront. This atmosphere, I look round, it's not just women, it's not just young girls who are here. There's men, there's young boys, everyone's involved in this. This is how you grow the women's game. This is phenomenal. But the way it's grown as well is the interaction from the players, the performance of the players, quite brilliant.
And it's England. It's England in a major final, and that is the jubilation that we're seeing around us. We were all so delighted when the men made it to Wembley last summer, but England men, England women, England under 23s, England under 18s, it's England in a major final, and it's brilliant.
Those three words, the England fans, they went early with it tonight, didn't they? I want to say them out loud now, because there is now only one match remaining. It's coming home. It does seem to be the belief of the 30,000 here inside Bramall Lane. After a performance like that, Izzy, you have to ask the question, what would be stopping them?
Nothing.
How do you stop these Lionesses?
You can't. I'm sorry, you can't. You won't, and you can't. Tomorrow, there's an excellent game between Germany and France. And honestly, I can see England beating both of them on their day in the final, and the girls have proven that they can live up. This music is so loud in here. The girls have proven that they can perform in this environment. Like Stephen said, this isn't fake, it's not generated atmosphere. This is genuinely people who are here to absolutely push England all the way. And in Wembley on Sunday night at 5 o'clock, there's going to be three times as many people inside that stadium than there is here. And the atmosphere is rocking.
And it's something we've remarked on throughout the tournament as the team. And it's something that Peter Gerhardsen, the Sweden manager, mentioned as well. sometimes in football, because you care so much about your club and your country, if it's not going well, you hear the home crowd get on the players' backs. You know, we talk about that all the time in domestic football. This has not happened at all at this tournament. Now, it helps that England have played very well, but Spain is a good example, where England were up against it. They were 6 minutes plus added time from going out. But the momentum and the support, it's all, come on, we're going to drag you through. We're together. We're going to drag you through. And it's going to be like that at Wembley as well. And as a player, Stephen and Izzy and Karen, I can imagine playing with that sort of atmosphere. We've talked about pressure of being the hosts all tournament. That is key, the way the attitude from the crowd throughout this tournament has been so positive and will be at Wembley.
Oh, man, this is amazing. I love it. I'm like over the moon. I don't think anyone actually understands the impact that this is going to have on English football. I really don't. I mean, we say it now, but in 5-10 years time, this is going to become the norm.
It's not just the fact they're winning, and it feels so unfair picking out individuals, but it is the quality, the manner in which they're doing it, the style. Alessia Russo, Vicky, I don't think it's an exaggeration to see that is one of the best goals I've ever seen live. I think they were the words that left your mouth. It makes you like nervously laugh. It's that good. In all the football I've watched, I've never really felt like that. You're not just watching that goal, but they are that good. And Izzy, they're that good across the entire pitch, which is what is so impressive about this in particular side.
Yeah, there were some pretty strange noises coming out of this lineup of five live tonight when Alessia Russo double nutmegged the Swedish goalkeeper and Anderson. But you know what, like, I actually want to say some of the England players and the staff, I'm looking at them down there on the touchline, and they've got like the heads in the hands as if to say, like, is this really happening? Like, yeah. Are we really this good? And do you know what? That comes from, we had the chat on air before kickoff about preparation and how well prepared England have been for every eventuality. And do you know those shocked reactions? That's when you are over prepared. They've prepared for everything above and beyond of anything that's ever going to happen in this tournament. And that's why it's so easy for them. Now, don't get me wrong, Sweden, they did have their spells tonight. But in every single department, England were better. They were first, they were quicker, they were faster, stronger, tactically more astute. And that is just, they're overly prepared. They just know everything and beyond. And that is come from Serena Beekman.
Yeah, I think the PA system's gone up another notch, and the Lionesses are going for a second lap of honour. I mean, you would, wouldn't you, after a performance like that? Rocking all over the world. Well, they're certainly rocking all over Europe as it stands. I mentioned Alessia Russo there. I think from the way we've described it, you'd be mad not to try and find a replay of this goal, because it was sensational, the finish. Just so so casual in a lot of ways. She was almost knocked off balance, then yet somehow managed with her back heel not make the goalkeeper find the back of the net. It does make her the joint second highest goal scorer in the tournament, with all four of her strikes coming as a substitute. Of course, it has set social media alight. Some big names chipping in as well. Eniola Aluko, Alessia Russo, the absolute audacity. I cannot get over what I've just seen. Wow, 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 in capital letters. What a goal. Gilberto Silva, what a goal. That might just be one of the best goals I've ever seen. Northern Ireland's Rachel Furness, Russo, take a bow. I suppose that's the other thing as well. You think about, if we're going to call her an impact sub, Alessia Russo coming on to help when perhaps things aren't going quite England's way. But she came on actually when England were in a pretty good position. You forget that she can take them still to that next level. The impact she has, Izzy, it works in so many ways.
Yeah, I said when she came on, the timing was perfect. I could see Ellen White drop in a little bit, performance level. On comes Alessia Russo to have an impact like that. But you know what, moving forwards, Alessia Russo will not want the title of Super Sub. This is for this tournament, and it'll be the way that she is, and she's been fantastic. We can't beat around the bush. That's what she's been. She's been super off the bench. But moving forward, a player of her quality and the age that she's at, she will move into her prime, and she will be
England's leading number nine for years to come as soon as Ellen White's finished. But Ellen White, what a role model for her.
But at this moment in time, this role suits her. And it might be something that Serena Wiegmans looked at and said, do you know what? You're not ready to start. Or Alessia Russo might find it easier coming off the bench. Some people do that when they get build momentum and then get that belief off the back of a tournament where they score ridiculous goals like that.
I think that's such a good point. And I think this is the question, because it's so easy to say, well, she and two and Kelly didn't get as much time tonight, but Kelly in the tournament, they come off and they make such an impact. But you don't want to mess with a winning formula from the bench. Like, people talk about not messing with the starting lineup in terms of a winning formula, but if it's working so well from a substitution perspective, that even if you might want to change things up for the starting lineup, you're also thinking, do I want to mess around with how well the substitutions are working?
Well, the big thing is being a former defender, and I'm looking at the bench and I'm seeing...